There is a story so strange in its implications that it defies ordinary classification.
I don't care if you've been asking your way through to wake you up when it's over. If you up, smash that like button. Welcome to Black and the Black Times Infinity. I'm your host, Cthulhu's Prodigy, coming to you live and direct from the drove. Smoke me out, fam, with that dank shit. On my left, the oldest ninja in the world, old ninja.
In hell.
Boy.
On my far right, engineering on the ones and twos, choke people on the threes and fours, Chronos.
He actually stole my intro. Like, seriously, how can I do something like that?
Goddamn. Last but not least, we got your boy Blue.
I was gonna clean my room, but I was killing God. Yeah, I was gonna smoke a joint, but I was killing God.
Good shit. Yeah. We back up in this motherfucker. Whomster have we got with us? Anybody?
One moment.
Wild Ob is the first in the chat room. We got somebody new, I think.
What's up, fam?
Mr. 619.
619, that sound like Dago.
Yeah, it is San Diego.
Yeah, let's do it.
But yeah, I haven't seen you in the chat before, so welcome to the live chat. Good to see you. Good to see your name, I guess. You know what the fuck
50 bucks, Professor X is on that list.
Mr. X. Yeah, Mr. X is listener of the week once again, followed closely by Dre Pettigrew. So like thank you very much. Love seeing new listeners.
Hell yeah. Old Ninja, we got to pour out some type of malt beverage.
Oh, it's Mike. Mr. 619 is Mike, Victor's friend.
There we go. Mike is the real one.
Oh, what's up? From WonderCon, remember?
Yep.
WonderCon. The dude with the beard.
Yeah.
Dude with the beard.
He could cosplay as Kratos.
There we go.
Boy.
We're going to bring it for you, Mike. Who we got, old ninja?
We're going to pour out some Schlitz.
Wow.
For our dearly departed boy, the artist formerly known as VC, famous Swedish DJ, born...
He was 28.
Yeah, his real name, though, I had it a second ago. Tim Bergling.
Yeah.
Damn, put his government name out there.
Yeah, well, he's gone now. He passed away a couple days ago, the 24th, 25th.
Something like that.
He was found in his hotel room, and he was in Oman. And no manner of cause of death has been released, at least not publicly.
Yeah.
He's most famous for EDM. He rose to fame when he did a remix, well, the song Levels, which is a remix of an Eartha Kitt song.
Yep.
Which everyone's heard of. It's movies, cell phone commercials, Super Bowls, it's played everywhere.
It was huge.
He actually started DJing when he was 16. Yep. He actually rose to fame when he was 16. 18, he was touring and he was partying. He actually drank so much that he got a pancreatitis.
Yeah, they're saying that's probably what killed him.
Pancreatitis?
Yeah, so it's possible, but he's been treated for it, but he may not, he's not cured of it. Yeah. So, but no official cause of death has been released. His family has asked for privacy in this matter, but he was a real one. I think his music is still played every day to this day. He's had a lot of tracks. He's worked with a lot of famous people toward the world.
He was literally one of those, like, Mount Rushmore level EDM DJs. Mm-hmm. He was big. The other ones he had was Fade Into Darkness, Wake Me Up, which was huge.
Yeah, Aloe Black. Everybody said it was an Avicii song, but it's like he just remixed it.
Yeah,
but it's a good song.
He
remixed it.
His remixes had like its own signature, and like like I said, he put on some amazing sets. Feeling Good was another one.
Mm-hmm.
Like if you haven't heard some of his music,
everyone's heard his music.
Not everybody.
Because he's been used in so much media.
If you think you haven't heard. You know what I mean? You're not as familiar with maybe his name. Because with EDM, a lot of people have heard different tracks, but they don't know which artist is associated with it. Just go ahead and listen to some of it. Download some Avicii, and you'll see the fucking artistry. He was one of my favorite. And he had his own podcast, too. That I used to listen to literally weekly, all about his mixes. So,
yeah, I mean,
he will be missed.
He was gone too soon. 28.
Yeah.
It's all bad.
Yeah, all bad.
Pouring out some more for Vern Troyer. most famously known for playing Mini-Me in the Austin Powers series.
Yep.
He passed away at the age of 49.
Damn, he was young.
Yeah. Well, I didn't know he was even that old. I keep thinking he was like in his 30s or something.
Well, if he was in his 30s, he'd have been like a kid in Austin Powers. Yeah. He'd have been like five.
Yeah. I thought maybe he's early 20s. I don't know. But yeah, Vernon Troyer, he actually was involved with like Playboy models.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So apparently he had married one, but it really wasn't. He annulled it the next day. He was married to a Genevieve Galen.
That was some drunk shit. Then if you annulled it the next day, goddamn.
He also has a sex tape out.
Goddamn.
Leaked by TMZ.
Leaked by TMZ.
Some crazy shit.
Oh man, there's somebody out there watching.
He's also appeared on Celebrity Wife Swap.
What?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's some other celebrity show he's on too that I watched where he basically got fucked up almost every day.
Mm-hmm.
And he was on a little fucking scooter and shit. It was hard to watch.
Yeah,
he has a YouTube channel, or I guess he still has one, but it was funny because on there he got a new Tesla, but not the car. He got the ones like the Power Wheel version of the Tesla.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and it was funny because like it was an unboxing and it was just him, like nobody to like help him like get it from the patio or from his porch or from his French door to the garage. So you see him trying to push it because he's like damn near the same size as the car. So he's like pushing it, and then eventually he gets his little rascal to kind of push it and bump it along. It was pretty fucking funny. But the open box was pretty hilarious too.
So he has a movie coming out this year. It's called Hipsters, Gangsters, Aliens, and Geeks. So all right. It's in post-production now. A popular show that people keep telling me about is Trailer Park Boys, because he's in that as well.
Well, that's what Matt watches that show.
Okay.
Yeah, I think all the people from Prereq Live watch that show.
Ooh, yeah, okay. So he's in that stuff too, but RIP to Mini-Me, Vern Troyer.
Yeah, man. RIP for real.
It wasn't a suicide?
So it's speculated that he may have done suicide by alcohol poisoning himself, but there's been no official word about his death.
So. Yeah, because I know that dude's been suffering from depression for like the longest time, and it's just kind of sad. Yeah.
But it sucks, but he's actually had a fairly decent career, more than a lot of other actors.
Oh, for sure.
Oh, yes.
All right.
RIP.
Y'all want to jump right into Kratos?
Fuck yeah. All
right.
Boy.
How many spoilers y'all giving out? The game ain't been out a week yet.
Let me just say that Kratos is probably the greatest dad of all time.
Wait. Greatest black dad.
Holy shit.
Well, I'm still playing it too, but can we not give the story spoilers? You know what I mean?
Like, yeah.
There's
so much that fucking happened.
Have you all three of you finished it?
Or no.
Okay. Wait, we're talking about
Kratos.
Okay. Yeah. Cool.
God of boy.
Yeah. What'd you call it? Dad of War?
Dad of War.
God damn, this fucking game is so good.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so good. Where should we start?
I guess in the beginning.
Let's start from the beginning.
Holy shit.
The beginning was epic.
Yeah. Holy shit. First, the game just starts off with you cutting down a goddamn tree. I'm like, okay, that's kind of cool. But then he fucking picks up like the whole goddamn tree and then carries along. I'm like, all right, he's still the God of War.
Yeah, like it was nothing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then kind of fast forward it a little bit. So the story starts with the his wife passing away, or I guess his kid's mom.
This will be light spoilers.
Yeah.
So this is just the beginning.
Yeah, this is the opening, like, first 10 minutes of it. But, somebody comes knocking on the door. Talking about.
Well, actually, let's rewind a little bit.
Yeah, that's way later.
So after he gets the tree that he pulled down was for the ashes for his. He needed to build a fire to build a pyre to burn his wife's body.
Yeah.
And that's where you see his son Atreus when he walks into his little house. You see Atreus is there and he just talks to him, boy.
Mm-hmm.
That's all he calls him the whole fucking. He barely ever calls him Atreus.
Mm-hmm.
See, barely every ever. Time he says Atreus, I always think it's Atreyu.
Yeah, I do too.
And I'm like, God dang it.
But then it looks like it's spelled like Artemis for some weird reason. I think it's just an AR in the beginning. But it's funny because he does call him by his name every now and then.
Every now and then.
If he's like kind of lingering behind, he'd be like, come on, boy, hurry up, catch up.
Yeah, like later in the game, their relationship gets better. But hey, we got to get to the beginning.
In the beginning.
All right, so the beginning, he goes to build a fire, you know, for his wife. He then sets her body on fire, puts her on the pyre, sets her on fire, and then he asks Atreus, you know, like, what has he learned? He said, you know, he knows how to hunt, so he asks him to go show him his skills to go hunt.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that part.
Yeah, it's kind of important. So he goes to, like, hunt this fucking crazy looking magical deer thing. Mm-hmm. And you help him shoot the deer and you wound him, and then you have to help him kill it because he told him to, like, basically stab it in the neck, and he's like, I don't know if I can do it.
And then
he basically, Kratos takes his hand and pushes the knife into this deer's fucking throat. And
this is actually the part they showed at E3.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But then right after that is where this fucking big ass troll snatches up that fucking thing you just killed, and then you get, like, your first, like, real battle. And it's pretty crazy because this thing is, like, it's gigantic and you basically fuck it up.
Yeah.
And then you go back to the house, and that's where Blue was talking about.
Real quick, you have, at the beginning of this game, you have no sense of time. How much time has passed between God of War 3 or Ascension, whatever the last game was. Chronologically, Ascension was the last game. I think that was technically a prequel, though. I don't know. I can't remember. But you don't know what time period you're in with his life. You don't know if it's been 1,000 years at the beginning.
Yeah.
Or if it's been maybe 40 years. You don't know.
You know it's been a pretty decent amount of time because, like, the scars he has on his body are, like, fading. And, like, he looks obviously older, but he's a god. So you know he's not supposed to be able to die.
Yep. Yeah, it's kind of weird to me because if he has scars, he's able to heal himself, though.
Yeah. Well, he got those scars before he was a god. That's why he got those scars. And one of the scars, even though after he was a god, it was through a sword that... Zeus.
Zeus
stabbed him through the fucking body.
Yep. But I just thought that was important to note because I was like, okay... The story of the previous games are kind of all over the place in terms of, like,
timeline.
They go back for prequels, but then they have the regular 1, 2, and 3. But you just don't know at the very beginning.
Yeah, you have no idea what time it is.
Yeah. We also forgot to mention that it's very obvious from the get-go that Atreus and Kratos, they really don't know each other. So I'm pretty sure Kratos was gone for most of his life.
Yeah.
So,
I guess, he probably was never around. He's like a typical black dad.
Well, I already said it on Twitter. He's blackest dad ever. He's European. It's fucking great.
Yeah, he does say that he was hunting a lot.
He says what?
He said Atreus says that his dad was hunting a lot, and he was never really around.
Yeah.
So, but then it was like, it's weird to me, like... Is he really his biological dad, or did he step in and is he stepdad?
That's what I've been kind of worrying about, too.
So I feel like there's hints that he may not be his actual biological father.
Well, one of the other quick things that I noticed right off the bat, there's a brand new voice for Kratos.
Oh, yeah.
And I love this fucking voice. Whoever the voice actor is.
So the guy played Talik, right?
Yeah. Is that him?
From Stargate.
He's great.
Yeah.
For whatever reason, this sounds more like Kratos than even the previous games, and that's all I knew back in the day.
Yeah, well, because he's older, and, like, his voice is a little deeper, and, like, just, like, the emotions that he has. First, forgot to mention, the fucking graphics on this game are goddamn amazing. Like, I'm an old-school PC gamer. This shit is, like, seriously PC level. Like, it's real fucking close. Yeah. Even on, like, a normal PS4 with, like, a normal 1080p screen, it's fucking amazing. And there's no goddamn load screens, ever, unless you die. Mm. There's no load screens. It's fucking great. And, like, just like the little things of when Kratos is, when you first see him, like the emotions on his face because his wife died. Like he doesn't really mention like his wife dying or like voice it at all, but you can see like the emotions in his face. Like everything's hard to do in the very beginning, you know what I mean? Like when his hand wraps come unwrapped and he's like tying it back together, you can see like the pain in his face.
Mm-hmm.
That shit was fucking dope. Anyway, back to when he gets back to his house. All of a sudden,
little cabin in the woods.
Yeah, all of a sudden somebody knocks on the fucking door, and so Kratos tells Atreus to get under the house. Basically.
Floorboards, yeah.
So he gets under the floorboards.
Do you have the subtitles on for the game? Because I have to turn mine on. Because sometimes the kid will be talking in the back, and you can't fucking hear him.
Oh,
you have to turn. You have to turn and like look at him for the sound to come through.
Oh, I got surround sound. So
yeah, I use my headphones.
Yeah.
All right, but what you're saying? So did the knock at the door?
Yeah. So then some guy comes out the door, and he's like some drunk-looking guy, way smaller than Kratos, and he's like, I forget the conversation, but he's like, basically, you got something that I want. Are you gonna give it to me or not?
Yep.
And then he's like, what the fuck you talking about? Like, Kratos has no idea who the fuck this guy is.
Leave.
He's like, you just get out. He tells him to leave. This guy's like, no, you're gonna give me what I want. And then he starts slapping Kratos. Slapping Kratos. I was like, what the fuck? You fucking slapped him?
Yeah, and it's more not phasing him. Yeah.
Yeah, I was just like, what the fuck?
Well, there's a part when, like, after he hits him a few times, he's like, man, I told you I didn't want to fucking do this. And he just...
hit him once, and the guy goes down.
Yep. Fucking flying.
To give a little context, the guy that comes up and slaps Kratos, this dude's like a fucking twig.
Well, he's known.
He's like this little skinny dude.
Yeah, like he looks like me.
Covered in tattoos.
Yeah, it's like literally like a regular person slapping the Hulk.
It's kind of Irish seeming too. But I was going to say, with the subtitles on, it shows like the caption, the person's name. So that it's listed, they list him as the Stranger.
Oh, yeah.
And they call him the Stranger later on too. But yeah, in the subtitles, it calls him the Stranger.
Well, I know what his name is now.
Well, yeah, like,
I don't
know now.
I haven't gotten to that part. But I do know that I hated this dude as much as I hated Kai Ling from Mass Effect 3. Holy fuck. I was like, dude, fucking die. Stop talking shit and fucking die.
But that already. Fucking first boss battle scene was so fucking amazing.
It's still my favorite. Shit.
So hold on. We didn't even get to like the actual battle. Yeah. All right. So he starts slapping Kratos. Kratos hits him. The guy falls down. He's like, whatever, he's done. You know, Kratos goes back to walk in his house. And the guy's like, oh, is that all you got? And then he fucking uppercuts Kratos. And Kratos goes flying. Like, basically, Superman hit him.
Yeah.
So,
shit.
And then fucking epic boss battle ensues. Fucking... the whole landscape is fucked up from this boss battle.
Yeah.
And this is the first boss battle. I'm talking about, like, the earth opens up, fucking mountains are fucking shaking and shit.
Fucking mountains are formed and fucking craters are put in place.
Mm-hmm. It was holy fucking shit. Insane.
It is Dragon Ball Z meets, like, Superman versus, you know, another Kryptonian level. That's what it felt like.
Yeah, what's
like,
so fucking crazy is that you're fighting this guy and you're like, okay, I'm putting a hurt on him because his power meter's going down. But all of a sudden, he fucking, like, knocks you back and just, like... fucking does like a Dragon Ball Z's like a Goku move and powers back up and he's got his full fucking energy back and he's not bleeding anymore, all of his scars are gone, he's back to normal.
Kratos does it too.
Did he
does
it? Oh, yeah, he does it later does it too.
But it feels like it takes more of a toll on Kratos than it does this other dude.
Oh yeah.
And like Kratos gets slower as you get to the different stages of the battle, so he's like, he feels it more, he's holding himself, like even when he thinks the battle's done, he's hobbling to the cabin.
Yep.
Yeah.
So it's like, he's like, it's like Kratos is old, but he can still put it down. But this new cat,
the Stranger,
that motherfucker. The Stranger was fucking shit up.
Apparently he can feel no pain.
Yeah.
So,
and he reminds you of that over and over again.
Over and over.
Can you make me feel? I was like, yo, this isn't that kind of
He's like, check out a
video game, yo.
Chucking harder, chucking harder, daddy.
That shit was dope. And we didn't even talk about like the new weapons and shit. Like so this game, I already had somebody complain to me about the game a little bit because they were saying it's so much different from the other games. This is not a hack and slash. If you're like a huge God of War fan and you like the hack and slash like thing, this is not a fucking hack and slash. You try to hack and slash, you're gonna get fucked up like real bad,
real fast.
Yeah, like the first level, like seriously, the first guys that I fought, I died like twice because I played on hard, not the hardest mode, but hard mode, and I died twice like a bitch because you can't just go in there and just like swinging your fucking axe around. So this new Leviathan axe, they basically made the best Thor game ever.
Yeah, basically.
Like you can throw this fucking axe and it comes back like Thor.
Yep.
And like the feeling that you get with the controller and like the slap that you get when it comes back, it's amazing every single fucking time.
Yeah, like even when the control, when it's coming back to you, your controller slowly vibrates until it hits your hand and you get like the quick thump of it. This game's fucking amazing.
Actually, that's probably what kills me the most is getting used to the controls. It took me a minute.
Yeah,
like I'm playing on the same setting as Kronos's, and like I literally died like 5-6 times just fighting like the first two fucking enemies, cause like what's fucked up is there's, you can see health past the boy and you can't get to it, you have to go through these dudes, and like I was like trying to fuck them up, and every time I like try to run, fucking I get fucked up. Like literally the first hit, quarter of your life is gone. Second hit, you're down to half. One more hit, you're fucking dead.
Yep.
I'm like, are you fucking serious? Like, and I, every time I kept trying to, I didn't know how to block, because at the very first stage it doesn't tell you how to block. So I kept getting hit. When I do find out how to block, I keep hitting the wrong fucking button and then fucking I get fucked up.
You need to learn. If you're playing on hard mode, you have to learn how to parry really quick in the game. If you don't know how to fucking parry, you're gonna get fucked up. If you don't know how to use Atreus, like Atreus for me is the best co-op NPC player of all fucking time.
Wow.
Hands fucking down.
So he at your level of the game has surpassed even Quiet.
Yes.
Wow.
He has, because so first of all, like throughout the whole game, you're basically kind of repairing your relationship relationship with Atreus.
Not even repairing it, you're fucking trying to build one.
Yeah, yeah, basically. And so it actually shows up in combat and like just talking to him and stuff. So,
oh man.
Like the way early in the game, all I can do is like shoot these little bullshit arrows to like annoy people. But like later in the game, he can like physically attack. He fucking drop kicks fucking giants.
Dude, yeah, he doesn't just drop kick them. He drop kicks them and they go fucking flying sometimes.
Yeah.
Like it's ridiculous how this kid evolves in the game.
Yeah, and he'll hold guys down for you. He'll fucking shoot magical arrows.
Oh, that's the best. When because he can hold them for quite a long period of time. And he says, Dad, here, I got him. And, so, like, you can run over and, like, practically finish them.
One of the things people were worried about when they saw some of, like, the previews, and obviously this didn't pan out, was that it would be one long, quote-unquote, escort mission.
That's what I was worried about,
and you learn right away that this is no fucking escort mission. And I like that. I like that aspect of it.
Like, my problem with it, I thought, like, okay, if your kid can get hurt, like he can take on damage, but when he takes on damage, like you can't use him. He's kind of like off to the side, like kind of down on his ass, but then he gets back up. But he doesn't die, which is awesome, because a lot of games, like if your side character dies, then you die and you have to play all fucking all over again.
Yep.
Which is hard. But
real quick too, for me, the thing that I liked right off the bat, the camera angle is nice and up close.
Oh yeah.
I mean, it's up close and personal. And then when they give you that prompt to be able to hit, I think, down on the D-pad, and it does that 180. That helped tremendously. I was like, man, more games need to have
that. What's kind of crazy, if you go into the settings under the video feed, on there it has like settings to change the motion blur and some other settings. So like, because when you pan around, like the world like kind of blurs when it moves, but you can change that to make it so it's either like a little bit sharper or whatever. Okay. But I just keep it the way it is. But just, yeah, I know what you're talking about. Like that whole switching around and like the environment and stuff. But one cool thing I noticed is that depending on where you're looking at, it also focuses on that point. So like, if like there's a scene where I look up at the night, this isn't a cutscene or anything, this is me playing the game. Like I looked up and I saw the, what's it, the giant snake's name?
Jormungandr.
Is it Jormungandr?
Jormungandr. I do that because the anime.
But what is it called? What do they call him in the thing?
The world snake.
Yeah, yeah. But so you look at the world snake, and like all of a sudden, like he is in focus, but like the foreground is a little bit blurry, which is kind of cool. So they definitely put some artwork into this.
Going off of that visual cue, there's actually enemies that will hit you that will obscure your vision.
Oh yeah.
For a short, small radius to where everything's cloudy, and like, for me, what I've used, I use Atreus to locate the enemy, basically. Because if you command him to fire arrows, he usually hits the target, even though I can't see them. Yeah. And I know which direction they're at.
Well, actually, you don't use the threat meter? The threat meter shows you where they're at.
The who?
The threat meter. It's at the, like, it surrounds you. It points to, like, where the fuck the guys are at.
In red.
It's white.
That's
only when they attack you, right?
That's when they attack you. And when they blur your vision, though.
If they're near you, it's a white threat meter that points to where they're at.
Usually they're not near me, especially one particular enemy. He manages to stay away. I don't want to give him away, because I fucked him up earlier today, but.
Yeah, the breadth and scope of this game is so fucking amazing. Basically, there's like I'll call it a hub world where you're at, and the fact that the hub world changes so dramatically, like over time. Mm-hmm. I don't want to say how, but it's like it's fucking amazing. Where you go back to basically the same spot, but it changes so dramatically over time. It's just it's fucking neat. And like every time I see Jormungandr, like at that fucking lake. Every time I see him, it's like, holy shit, that's a big ass fucking snake. He's literally, his head is the size of a fucking mountain.
When he fucking talks,
he's just like looking around. Oh yeah.
When he talks, holy shit, dude, it's insane. It's so bassy and you don't understand what the hell he's saying, but it's just super fucking loud. It's like somebody talking really slow in another language. But like the guy we met at WonderCon. Imagine his voice,
Kevin.
But like,
oh, yeah, 50. Yeah, yeah,
but times 50, because holy shit.
It makes Kevin Gorvo sound like me.
Real quick, one of the other things, the whole point of the beginning of the game is to place the ashes for his dead wife on a mountain.
On the highest mountain.
In the realm.
Yeah, and off you go on this adventure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That, just to say, that's how it starts.
And what's interesting is, I'm gonna say Kronos, Kratos, his main mission is just to fucking get up to the top of the mountain and put the wife's ashes up there. But all this other shit just keeps happening. And he like, at first he's kind of, I don't want to be doing this shit. I just go off and do this. But like, they slowly have the key keep doing all these other little puzzles and challenges to be able to reach the top of the mountain. But it, during this whole entire event, they're built. He's rebuilding his relationship with his son, which is kind of cool.
Yeah. While you're doing this, you're also exploring Norse mythology, and the wife has like a mystery to her. So like as you go, you start finding out as a player, you start finding out more about his wife. In fact, Hobby from PlayStation Trophy Hunters, he was like, oh, I know so much about Norse mythology, I think I know who Kratos' wife is. I was like, wait, what? He didn't want to give it away, but he was saying there's like all these clues that they keep giving you on who she might be.
There are clues. Well, especially the axe.
Well, yeah, as I'm getting through the game, I'm getting more and more stuff, and I'm like, oh, okay. I mean, I don't know as much Norse as I do Greek mythology, but there's just like, because most of them are a lot of names that I can't even fucking pronounce and shit.
Yeah.
It's all fucked up, but it's interesting to me because right now we have, we're about to get Infinity War, and we have Thor painted as a certain way. In the game, they have Thor painted as kind of an asshole.
He is an asshole, and so in Norse mythology, he's an asshole too.
Yeah, so they're like, there's all this shit about like, and it's funny to me because like, people that are within the world are talking shit about Thor, and then Kratos just talks shit about any and every god.
Well, he's got a history with them gods.
Yeah.
If Kratos finds out you're a god, you're dead, basically. But one, I was gonna say that like a lot of the references they make to, what is it, Greek mythology or is it
Norse mythology?
Norse mythology. Yeah, a lot of the stuff that they mention is just stuff I've heard from like Thor the movies, like the whole Ragnarok and
the Bifrost,
and the what's it called? What's the name of the land they're on?
Oh, Midgard.
Midgard.
Yeah, there's Midgard.
It's kind of like the Niflheim. Rainbow Bridge a little bit.
Yeah, Niflheim and Alfheim and probably a bunch of other
Heim. The nine realms from Thor, right?
Yeah, the nine realms.
You go to all nine. Yeah.
I've hit two so far, I guess.
I've only gone to one.
You start in Midgard.
Midgard.
I've been to Fairyland.
Well, I can go to Hell. I haven't been there yet, but
yeah, I can go there too, but I heard it was like crazy hard.
Yeah.
Yeah,
this game is a fuck around with difficulties.
It sure fucked up.
There's shit that'll one hit kill you.
Yeah.
Like in almost the beginning of the game.
Oh yeah, no.
That one hit kill you.
Yeah.
Cause when you like typically with the God of War games, you don't start off like super powerful like you was. Well, I guess the second one you did actually start off powerful.
But then you
get stripped of that power.
Yeah.
But this game, you start off with like the low of the low, and like your axe, all it can do, you can throw it and stuff. And it one of the powers of the axe is that it can freeze things. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't, it only does it on weaker things, but like larger animals, it doesn't work too well on those.
No.
It's just fucking crazy. It's funny to me that this, like, as I'm playing and it has this, like, semi-open world type thing, there's, like, mini dungeons that are there.
Yeah.
And I'm like, holy shit, like, I'm exploring this area and it's got, like, these little, like, not so little mini bosses that I'm like, fuck, you gotta, like, figure out an attack strategy to take them down and shit.
What'd you find of Valkyrie?
I have not gotten there yet.
Fuck those fucking things. That's all I gotta say. I thought I faced, like, the hardest things. But yeah, Travelers and fucking Valkyrie so far have given me like probably the most trouble out of anything.
The werewolves fuck me up.
They ain't got shit on me.
Yeah, after I figured out like especially like parrying and the wolves, you can fuck them up with a good parry.
I don't even parry. I'm just fucking rushing.
I don't rush them.
Let me say this real quick too. One of the things that was a huge change was really the whole inventory system.
Oh yeah.
And the runes, all of the stuff with the level, the leveling up and upgrades for not just Kratos but also the boy.
Yeah.
And boy. I thought that was just kind of a cool change to kind of add that level of complexity, because there's right off the bat, right when you put the goddamn disc in, there's so many fucking options for how you want to kill things.
Yeah.
There's a shit ton. And then the level of complexity just builds and builds and builds and builds and builds.
And it all depends on the way you play too, because like say if you're more of a close combat person, you can build Kratos where his he's more stronger when he's doing fighting things close, where you can make it where you know you're constantly throwing your axe and doing more damage that way, which is kind of cool.
I was worried about like the combat when you're axes away from you.
Oh, no.
Boy, was I wrong.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Because he throw them things just like he has when he had, like, the Hercules gloves or, yeah. you know, I mean, he can throw down with or without his axes. Mm-hmm. He is not dependent on his axe for shit.
Yeah, there's I was going to say there's certain parts where you can't use your axe. Like, you have to use your hands because either A, the enemy can block your axe, or B, your axe is stuck somewhere and you can't use it because if you take it, it's going to...
It'll kill you.
It'll kill you, basically. Yeah, so, it's kind of crazy.
It is crazy.
Yeah, it's also the way they kind of even that out, too, is that if your axe is away, you build what's called a stun meter, and then once it fills up, you can basically instant kill an enemy. Mm-hmm. So, say if you throw your axe because there's, like, one guy that's, like, a smaller guy, but you know you can't fuck with him, you can throw the axe at him, freeze him, and then use your hands to, like, stun somebody, and then you can stack stun with Atreus with his arrows, because Atreus, especially when you juggle him.
Yeah.
When you juggle him and use Atreus' arrows, the fucking stun shit, the stun meter goes way up.
Yeah.
And you can just one-shot kill him. And it's, when you kill him, it's pretty fucking dramatic. Like, you rip them apart, tear their fucking heads off, fuck them up.
Oh, yeah. Like, some of the scenes for that, because God of War is known for having, like, crazy-ass blood scenes. Like, when he takes out an enemy, he, like, rips them apart. But the cutscenes in this one are fucking, like, amazing. Like, when you're fighting, like, a giant gorilla, like, he fucking jumps. This is in the first scene. I think, oh, no, that's the trophy fault first. But you fight this one gorilla, and you're, like, you literally, like, throw this guy down on the ground, and you take your axe, and you whack him in the mouth just once, and then you hit him again to split his mouth open.
Love it.
It's so fucking glory.
One of the things that I got to give some credit for, even though, obviously, God of War has always had epic fights and boss battles and all that other shit, it was the quiet moment that fucking fucked me up, where he's like, I'm going to almost put my hand to console my son, because he's going through some shit. The boy looks about 9, 8 years old or whatever, and he's seeing some shit he ain't never seen before, like some fucking brutality of war, and he's like, should I comfort him? Nah, fuck that motherfucker. Yeah. Man up!
And he tells him that too, like, it's fucking crazy.
Yeah, I mean, you can see the struggle of father and son. I mean, because this is really about a father and son journey, and it's like, there's a scene where you actually will step out for a pack of cools. And when you when you come back, he is super pissed at you.
Yeah, he is.
Where and, you been?
Yeah,
it's crazy too, because like him being pissed off carries out like the next scenes are him just constantly being pissed at you. Like, and his attitude is in
voice. He smart mouths Kratos. I'm like, boy, you realize a flick of his finger will knock your head off. And he just is mouthing off.
But actually, that scene cemented that Atreus is a fucking badass. It's basically he goes on a fucking murderous rampage. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you're just like, what the fuck?
He does. He does. And I was, but he's super pissed. And he's like, I wasn't gone that long. He's like, you left me.
Yeah.
Nigga.
But think about this.
Why you ain't my real daddy?
With all the five or six games in the God of War series, who has mouthed off to Kratos and lived?
Nobody.
Almost nobody, right?
Yeah.
And there's another guy, too, that's pretty funny that you haven't met. There's another thing and later on the game that mouths off to him a little bit, but it's funny though.
Good.
So
well, one thing we kind of didn't touch on is too much with the kid. What's it, how you say his name again?
Atreus.
Boy.
Boy. So with the boy, one cool thing about him is that, you know, he actually is very smart. Like, he's going around like reading things for Kratos, like there'd be symbols and stuff, translating and stuff, but he's also taking notes. Like, he has a book that you can go back and read. But what's cool about that is that after you kill like a villain or a monster for the first time, he actually takes notes on how to fucking kill it again. Like, in his notes, he'll tell you, like, oh, so this creature right here can block my dad's axe, so you have to use your fist to take him out. Like, so if you're having a struggling fighting a character, just look in your, is it like, I think it's called the Codex.
Codex, yeah.
And in there, will tell you how to beat that monster, which is kind of cool.
If you faced him enough times.
Yeah.
So, if it's just like once, he probably won't tell you how to, like, beat him.
Okay.
Is Kratos, I know he's illiterate for Norse, like, language. Was he actually able to read Greek? I can't remember.
Yeah.
He was? Okay.
He doesn't read anything in Norse or anything. There's a bunch of different languages.
Yeah, that's true.
That apparently the son can read that he can't. So
yeah,
that's another thing coming handy.
Yeah, because he mentions like Elvish and then the normal Norse and then like some other shit that's like ancient.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Some kind of ancient shit, like all kinds of shit. And I'm just like, oh, okay, this is interesting. And then just like, I do like the dynamic of like the disconnected father-son thing. I mean, but this is their journey where they're, you know, trying to rebuild everything. And it's kind of interesting because, like, you see how Kratos is trying to teach this boy to be a man, but he has trouble trying to teach the boy empathy.
Well, think about who his examples are. Zeus was not a great dad.
Yeah. But well, Zeus wasn't his dad anyway.
Or, well, no, who was it?
They never go into like who his dad was.
Yeah, I don't think
okay.
they do.
All right.
So maybe Kratos didn't have no daddy. Never know.
Well, but it's also hard for him. Like, if you played the previous God of Wars, like, you understand why it's hard for him to, like, actually have a child, because he fucking killed his kid and his wife.
And so he has the example. He's wearing the example.
Yeah, yeah. So that's why he's, like, super conflicted about doing anything with his kid. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure he's worried about killing him. So.
Didn't he get, wasn't he, like, under some magic spell that caused him to kill his family?
Yeah,
or?
Basically. Okay. He was, like, bloodlust after he died and came back and made that deal with, what's his name?
Ares?
Oh. No, Ares.
Yeah, I thought Ares is the one who tricked him, because he hated him so much.
Another cool thing with the kid, with boy, is that he will alert you to stuff too. So like, if somebody's about to attack you from behind, he'll warn you like, hey, behind you or whatever, or he will like later on in the game, he has the ability to like throw health to you if you're needed, which is fucking perfect. There have been so many times I've been near dead, and he will just throw me a little extra health thingy, and I'd be like, oh, cool. But it's not just health that he has on him. It'll be health that's on the ground. If he comes across it, he'll throw it at you and be like, here, catch that.
And it can literally, like, after you die, it can save your life with a resurrection stone.
That's pretty dope.
So that comes in real fucking handy.
One of the things I did not like about like some of the Arkham games, even though they were fantastic, was they would surround you, and one by one, an enemy usually would come up to you, and you'd fight them, and then another one would come, usually afterwards. That is not how God of War works with its AI.
No.
That's how I died in the beginning, because I get double stuck. Like, literally three hits, you're fucking dead.
Yeah.
So you get caught slipping, you're fucked.
Yeah.
I was like, fuck, fucking controls.
I like it, though, because either you look like you're fucking badass, or you look like you're the weakest bitch ever.
Yeah,
like,
seriously. Fucking fucked up. And then I was like, how am I supposed to fight these big-ass creatures? I'm like, fuck, one hit, and I'm fucking dead. Pretty much, but working out a combat strategy for different enemies has worked out. Yeah. And it's cool because, like, if you die, there's hints on how they tell you tips on how to take down that particular monster.
And you can adjust your runes, you can adjust your armor.
Yeah,
yeah.
You know, if you have them.
Yeah.
If you have them. But, so,
I mean, if you're playing on hard, this is some of my tips generally in the game. Is learn how to fucking use Atreus. Like, if you're not using them, you're playing the game fucking really wrong. Yeah. Like, you're dying for a reason.
Agreed.
You have to use Atreus, because first of all, he deals very small amount of damage early in the game, but later in the game, if you upgrade his shit first, all right? Anytime you see his shit, just upgrade his shit first, because he ends up dealing, like, the way I have him right now, he deals massive amounts of damage to, like, multiple enemies at the same fucking time, and he distracts enemies. And there's enemies in the game that have fucking shields that are really fucking hard to do anything with, and you basically have to wait for Atreus to do something.
Mm.
And right now, he can, like, sweep the enemy and shit like that, or, like, distract him, and then you can hit him. But, definitely learn how to use Atreus. The game doesn't do a very good job of explaining, like, what you're supposed to do, like, as far as, like,
the menu system
goes. Yeah.
I'm sorry, as far as the what goes?
The menu system and leveling up and your XP points.
Yeah, it's a little weird.
Yeah, so in the game, you're probably playing, you're like, oh, I got all these XP points, why am I still level 1? Your XP points don't mean shit. Your XP points are basically only to, like, gain new skills. Mm-hmm. That's it.
They're like credits.
Yep. Yeah, for you and Atreus.
Yeah, it's literally credits.
Yeah.
To upgrade your gear, too.
No.
Yes and no.
No. Well, it's like your axe. It's just your axe skills.
Yeah. So it's your axe, trails, and...
That's basically it.
Yeah, because you have to go to the shop to upgrade your gear.
Yeah. And then think of, if you ever played Destiny, think of like your upgrade system as basically Destiny.
Hmm.
The better gear you have, the higher your level will go. Like your actual level.
Okay. That makes sense now. Because I'm like trying to upgrade, because you can upgrade your gear, and I'm like, why is my fucking level still like kind of the fucking same?
Yeah, look, it doesn't really explain it. It took me a while to figure that shit out. So if you're upgrading your gear, or if you're going to buy new gear, look at it first, and then when you're buying it, if there'll be like an arrow next to like your number for your level. If it's a green arrow up, that means it's better than what you got. If it's a red arrow down, it means it's worse than what you got. But that's with a caveat.
Yeah.
All right. So the caveat is, if you have those fucking rune stones and you have rune stones in there, that changes the level or the efficacy of that item. And also, if you already leveled up that item, obviously, if you level it up, say you have like one item that's level 4, all right, okay. And you upgrade it all the way up to level 4.
Yeah.
And you see an item that looks badass that you can buy, but it's only like a level 3.
Yeah.
Look at like there's notches next to the number. If it has like 2 more notches, that means you can go up to like level 5 or 6 or whatever.
Oh.
So it'll okay. Eventually it should be better than what you have, but it just seems like it's lower right now because what you have is fully upgraded.
Yeah, you have
further to, on that, like, there's color codedness too, right?
For like rareness and stuff. Yeah, like
yeah. Okay. Rarity. Yeah. But I also look at the stats. So every time you do.
Yeah, that's just important.
You look at your armor on the right hand side, it gives you the stats for each one. Like Cronus was saying though, you can add runes that will increase certain stats, especially like luck and cooldown. Like, if you want to use your powers more, you want to use runes to increase your cooldown so you can throw your axe more or bust out your super moves more.
Can and I then,
luck, I'm still trying to figure out exactly how that works out, but I'm just
it helps whatever. You get more money when you break into chests and stuff, and, you know, you get a higher chance of enemy dropping health or more coins.
And, it's also with some of your runes, there where it has, like, slight or moderate chances to do things, it'll up those chances.
Yeah, love looking at like comparison because you can compare on the fly what you have versus what you have, and like Cronus says, you can also look at those notches because if you can go up above more than what you already have, you just invest the money into it and then you'll be able to level it up.
Go ahead and then I'll give it.
I was just going to ask for like all three of your Kratos, what does he look like from a defensive and offensive standpoint right now?
So mine is mostly offense because in hard mode doesn't really fucking matter how much fucking life you have. So I mean, I have a shitload of life, but I can still get one hit KO'd. So my shit is mostly offense. A lot of cooldown because I'm using. I try to use my fucking light and heavy like rune attacks like a lot. So like if you watch the, I did like a clip of like me playing like a basically a small horde.
Oh, okay.
And I used fucking those rune attacks.
Was that on Twitch? I'm sorry.
No, it was on
Facebook.
On my Facebook.
Account. Okay.
But I need to switch it out.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Well, for me, I think I'm more offensive because, like, I'll run back and kind of hold back and let my boy do his job, and then I'll come through and kind of wreck shit again. But yeah, more my strength is probably the highest percentage than all my other things.
Wow. Okay.
But then my cooldown is up there too, so I can go back and use my rage mode and stuff like that. So it kind of works out for me.
Yeah, I'm the same way because I'm playing on the same level. I'm trying to strength, offense. I'm trying to fuck people up so they don't fuck me up. I also am trying to do the cooldown as well. So I'm trying to use runes so I can use my powers more. I actually got 2 new ones to give my power set. They come back so fast now. I'm able to like dish out power, like the light and heavy attacks faster. So I'm trying to punish people pretty much. So I'm trying to balance that. But I'm also trying to increase my defense now. But usually the armor's kind of taking care of that. But any kind of runes that I get that increase strength, I'm using that shit.
That's strength though.
Strength though.
One kind of interesting thing about the skill set, I thought 5 was the max. Like, I thought you just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that's it. Like, 5 is the cap. But I fought enemies that are like 8s and 9s and shit like that. These are one. These guys killed me like instantly. Yeah. But I guess you can go higher than 5.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah, because when you're like what is it called?
I got 5 right
your,
now.
Yeah, and your skill sets, like it all of, like once you level up your axe, it goes up to 5, and that's it. Like for you to unlock. So I'm wondering if there's gonna be more that gets unlocked.
Well, your actual level goes up higher than 5, but I think your actual axe level only goes to 5. Well, because your skills. You only have so many skills you can get.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, it's, I think Blue had talked about, like, you can actually tailor your Kratos to how you play. Like, you can do, like, let's say you're fighting a horde, like a huge group of people, and you keep dying or whatever. You can switch out your attacks to where you can deal area attacks versus doing like lots of throws or whatnot. So you can punish large groups versus doing like one-on-one kind of stuff. So you can play with how, you know, you can change it to your play style to deal out punishing attacks or do more defensive type things or more magic, especially if you level up Atreus or the boy to help you out. You can tailor him as well to to do more offense or defense for you.
That customization.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, because people were, who was it? The professor was asking for help about, because he's playing on hard too, and he was just like, he's getting fucked up by like maskers or enemies. And yeah, if you, you basically have to use some kind of rune attack if you're getting fucked up by an Atreus, like way more. Because Atreus, not only does he deal damage, like I said, but he'll take the focus of some of the enemies away from you. So that comes in real fucking handy.
Get him in the back.
Yeah. Stab motherfuckers. Yeah. Drop him in the face.
That's kind of crazy.
Good shit.
I mean, yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah, he's definitely a good distraction. I feel bad when he gets fucked up because they knock his ass around. Mm-hmm. And then when you die, he's like, don't leave me. I'm like,
yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. And I feel bad too. I'm like, oh, I let my son down.
Yeah. And he runs at you. Especially when you have the rune thing, like the resurrection stone, he runs at you. And every now and again, like, I don't press it because I'm just like, well, I got fucked up.
So yeah.
I'm not going to lie. Yeah. So if you're playing the game and you got fucked up, don't use your fucking rune.
Yeah.
This might seem like it's or the resurrection stone. Just fucking die.
Yeah.
Because first of all, you get all your health back. And there's not really a whole lot that.
Well,
I'll give it up a whole lot.
I would usually use it if the enemy power is like weak, and I'm like, I'm dying.
Oh, close. Yeah.
If I fucked up everybody and there's that one last dude and he got a lucky hit, I'm coming back and I'm fucking you up.
Yeah, but don't just run in and be like, oh, I fucking died with one hit and then just come back. No.
Yeah.
That's
bad strategy.
That's the thing that sucks. If I already have like a little bit, be a little half, and I have to fight a horde of people, I'll just fucking die and then just come back. Depending on where the checkpoint is, though, because sometimes it might be before a previous activity, which could fucking suck.
Yeah.
But
well, I know this is going to be ongoing because it sounds like I'm early on still. I'll fucking admit I'm maybe like 5 or 6 hours in, but it sounds like everybody's about to maybe beat it by the time next week rolls around. Maybe.
Probably can. Yeah.
Not me.
I mean, if I keep playing it, but I don't know because I've been playing. Yeah, it's a long game. I'm exploring a lot because I keep finding like hidden areas, and then it turns into a fucking dungeon. I'm like, oh, motherfucker.
Not a single fucking side story has seemed repetitive to me. So
that's great. That's a great sign.
Yeah.
That's a great sign, especially for a big game.
Mm-hmm.
Should we switch it up a little bit?
Actually, why don't we give our scores? I mean, should it's been...
Well, do we want to wait?
Well, I was going to say wait till everybody...
Wait till
we eat
it?
Well, yeah.
All right.
I mean...
Yeah, I mean, we haven't beaten it. I mean,
you can give an initial...
change.
Yeah, you can give an initial score.
I mean, dude, you could get to... It could be like Mass Effect 3, where it's super great. You get to the end, and it's like, oh, a fucking weak-ass hand job.
I like the ends. I like all the endings on that game.
Red, blue, and green.
Fucking gay.
We are literally one day away from potentially the biggest movie in the comic book universe, Avengers Infinity War.
Mm. Oh, I thought you meant Batman versus Joker.
This motherfucker. Let's speculate a little bit. Obviously, nobody has seen it quite yet besides a few critics, a few press folks have actually seen it. I appreciate everybody who has not spoiled shit online because fuck those motherfuckers. Let's stick with money to begin with. Y'all, what do you think opening weekend we're going to look at for this movie? Bear in mind, Black Panther did about, I think it was 240.
Opening?
Yeah.
Is this getting a worldwide release?
Or I believe it's worldwide at the same time.
So it's not out in the UK already?
No. That's why they pushed it back to April 27th.
Okay. So I'm going to say maybe $300 million opening weekend.
That's, wow. Yeah.
Yeah, an extra $60 million.
That's big. The pre-sales are larger than any other any other MCU movie. Like, I think the last top five MCU or top seven MCU movies combined almost.
Mm-hmm.
So it's crazy.
So I'm predicting an extra $60 million. Extra $60 million than...
Than BT.
Than Black Panther. So $300 million opening weekend.
I'm going to say...
And that's including tomorrow, which will be Thursday.
I'm going to say 260.
260. Okay. Yeah. Worldwide.
Yeah, worldwide.
All right. I'm going a little high. Mm-hmm. I'm going to say 380, which is...
Wow. That'd like break a record, wouldn't it?
I don't know. We'd have to look that up.
Yeah, because... Sure, I mean,
I'm
going
to say it's going to get close to 400.
He is saying worldwide, so, I mean, that could be...
Oh, okay. Well, I guess
different. When you add Europe and Asia in there.
And parts of Asia, and then, like, the Latin Americas and, you know, everyone else. That might be low.
God damn, now you know what? No, I'm going to go a nice round number. I'm going to go on 400. All I'm going 400. 400 mil.
Respectable.
We'll wait for, we'll definitely hear Blue's take once. Yeah, he's rolling his way back up in here.
I don't know if this is domestic or not.
You're looking at an all-time record?
Yeah, because the biggest all-time record was 247 million.
Oh, because it has a...
What movie was that?
The Force Awakens.
That was only 247, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, that might that
for
might
opening
be,
weekend.
That might be domestic. Actually, if you click the actual movie, it should break it down worldwide, domestic, and like maybe a couple other.
While he's looking that up, Blue, what you got is an estimate for a worldwide on Infinity War opening weekend?
Opening weekend?
Yep.
I think they might. Well, I haven't heard any because when Black Panther came out, people were bragging about that they were already breaking records mm-hmm. for pre-sales, and I haven't really heard much about Infinity War.
It's actually done more in pre-sales.
Oh, it has? Yep. Okay, I haven't heard anything. Well, I've been killing God, so.
Shit, but makes me want to change my number.
I might, maybe 200 mil open the weekend?
That's lower than Black Panther, just so you know.
Oh, is that really? Oh, fuck. 300 mil open weekend?
That's your number, don't.
Yeah, that's your number.
Be confident with it. I said 400.
Yeah, I want to say 420.
All right, Kronos, you found some.
I'm trying to find the worldwide one.
Oh God, damn. Yeah.
You choked all over that shit.
Because I busted out.
You gotta swallow the nut, man.
Oh man.
Dribble.
Yeah. No, I was drinking this beer and like it. I didn't know it was an IPA, but it's got a bit of a kick to it.
Mm. Oh wow. Okay. So yeah, I was way off. The Fate of the Furious actually is the number one spot.
Wow. What numbers?
With $541 million
for opening weekend.
Yeah, worldwide.
Holy shit, that's crazy.
Yeah.
Wait, we're talking about opening weekend or for worldwide?
Yeah, you said worldwide.
Oh, yeah, I gotta raise my number up a little bit.
I guess I gotta raise mine too. Shit. So, I'll say 400 then. Fuck it, I guess.
Yeah,
I'm gonna do 450. Mm.
450. You got the highest one.
No, 450.01.
Price is right.
Price right shit.
Good shit. We want to make any speculation predictions on Homestead will be killed.
Wait, did your guys already say what Mr. 619 said for opening weekend?
What he said?
Oh, no, I guess he was talking about Wonder Woman. Sorry.
Oh, Wonder Woman made 450. Worldwide.
But yeah. That wasn't opening weekend, though.
No, I think that was.
Like, no.
No, yeah, no, it wasn't.
Yeah, that's. I think they were in the 100 million mark for opening weekend or something Wonder Woman, which is great. Don't get me wrong.
Trying to find it.
But while he's doing that, Homestead have gonna die. Predictions.
You want to start with yours?
Yeah. I'm gonna go with Cap as my first one. I think Cap's gone.
So, I mean, I have like a little.
Go ahead.
Little thing about it.
What you got?
What are you gonna say?
No, he was talking about worldwide for this one, not Wonder Woman.
What I'm gonna say is, I think someone from each mini group,
which are,
will end up losing someone. So you have the basically Team Cap. You have Cap Circle, which is basically Bucky and Falcon, pretty much. And then you have Iron Man Circle. Well,
Ant-Man was in there too, at least from Civil War.
Yeah, but not. I'm saying like their little, like if you look at it as their series of movies,
okay.
Who's more prominent?
Gotcha.
So with Iron Man, it's usually Pepper. It's Pepper. I'm gonna put in Black Widow and then Happy Hogan.
Did you just put Pepper in as a superhero? What the fuck?
No. As part of his inner circle.
Oh, okay.
Like, I mean, anybody could die technically, but I'm gonna pick people from like each little mini group. I'm gonna start off by saying Vision. Vision's gone.
Mm. Oh yeah, he's gotta die. Yeah.
Vision's gone. And then Scarlet Witch will either leave the team because of his death, or will try to get some kind of like get back and get fucked up and die.
Hopefully, Vision gets that pussy though. First, I want him to get that pussy.
We'll see how it goes.
The magical nuts.
Yeah.
From Cap's like inner circle, I'm gonna say Falcon dies.
Quick question for Vision. Do you think his sperm looks like those little things from the Matrix? The little.
little tips over the back.
Green ones and zeros.
God dang.
All
right. I'm going to say Falcon dies from Tony. Oh, War Machine from Iron Man's circle. I'm saying War Machine goes.
Is he even coming out? He's got a broken back.
He's on the poster.
He's going to go to Wakanda.
He's fucked up.
Yeah. I'm saying, so basically you get rid of all the darkies except for Black Panther.
All the darkies.
Yeah. I mean, they hit their darkie limit, so.
Dude, Black Panther is immortal now.
Yeah, but I mean, Black Panther kind of eclipsed everyone else, so I'm going to say Falcon goes. War Machine goes, Vision goes, Scarlet Witch will either retire or be gone, or quit, or die or retire. I'm gonna say Nebula
Damn, you listed everybody. Yeah, because
Nebula. I mean, for one, not everyone's really invested in Nebula, and so like her, she's a daughter of Thanos. She wants to kill him really badly, and I think she's gonna overstep, come at him, and then they're gonna fuck her up.
I was gonna say they're gonna fuck. I was like, oh, I've seen this. No, I've seen this. He's gonna fuck her up.
That's his daughter.
Yeah, I'm gonna say Mantis goes.
On Pornhub still.
The reason why I picked these two because this will open up a spot for Captain Marvel. So she'll probably will end up working with Guardians of the Galaxy and either Guardians 3 probably she'll show up. Gives room for Nova as well for Guardians. And let's see, who else did I have?
God damn, man.
I think that's it.
All right, Kronos, who you got for who dying? Homestead of dying in this movie? Predictions.
I think Rocket's going to die. Fuck him.
Ooh, hot takes.
fucking trash panda.
damn.
Who else think is going to die? I think... I don't know if Bucky doesn't die, he's either going to get seriously injured and brought back by Wakanda technology, and then he's going to be the White Wolf, which is who he should be, because they call him the White Wolf, right?
They did.
So I think he's going to take over the mantle of the White Wolf, even though it's a totally different person. Who else? I think Tony's going to become seriously injured or die. Die.
Damn.
Okay.
I think that, what's the guy's name? The fucking right-hand man to goddamn Sorcerer Supreme.
Strange.
No, what's the guy next to him?
The black guy, right?
No, not the black guy.
It's Wong.
Yeah, Wong. Yeah. I think he's going to die.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Side character.
Yeah, right. Side character. I don't think that's about it. This is going to be more like probably going to die, too. I'd say half of humanity is going to die.
Yeah.
At least.
Blue.
For me, kind of piggybacking off what Odin just said, based off of groups, I think under Black Panther's flag, it's going to be, I think Michonne might die.
Ooh, hot takes.
Yeah.
All right.
I think her character might die in Infinity War. God damn, I can't talk, like always. But I think Captain America is going to die just because I think he's tired of playing the role, so they're going to kill him off anyway. Same with Tony Stark. He's kind of...
Both.
This would be like his 18th movie or some shit.
God damn.
I mean, he was in Spider-Man, Homecoming. He's in all this other shit, so maybe he might die.
He started Spider-Man.
Mm-hmm.
Basically.
His movie.
I think that's it for who I think are gonna like guarantee die. Maybe Star-Lord might get killed.
Oh, really?
Wait, who?
Star-Lord.
I don't think you can kill off Star-Lord.
I don't think Star-Lord's going. I forgot to mention Tony. I don't think he's going to die, but I think he will retire. That way it leaves it open to him doing like cameos or like show up in the future MCU.
Can I be a new, what's the name?
Can I add one quick thing?
Nick Fury.
I was just going to mention him. I hope he's in this. I haven't seen any indication that he's in this movie.
I don't think he's in it.
Well, the last time we saw him was in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Or Winter Soldier from the movies.
Yeah, Winter Soldier.
Oh, yeah, he was right.
That was like the last one.
Let me say this unequivocally. God damn it, Nick Fury is the one who actually started the Avengers initiative. Mm-hmm. If he truly isn't in this movie, wow. To me, that's like a slap in the face at Samuel Jackson and the character and the MCU, period.
Yeah.
You kind of just have to have him. I don't understand. They better explain that.
I don't think he is in the movie. I'm also going to speculate that at the end credits, we will see the Skrulls. We'll get introduced to the Skrulls.
Okay. All right.
Which will probably lead into Captain Marvel.
Can I just say something real quick, too, about Skrulls? I hope that people who don't read comics at all won't see the face of the Skrull, even though they're green, and think, hey, Thanos kind of looks like that with the chin all scriggly or whatever, Thanos is purple. I know for comic fans, we don't make that, connection or whatever. It doesn't even cross our mind. But if this is your first time seeing this purple alien for the most part and these green aliens that kind of look a little similar, I don't know. You got to make that distinction very clear.
I feel like the Skrulls are more goblin looking. They got them big ass Spock ears and shit.
It's the chin though.
Yeah.
Even though Thanos is way bigger, but he's a mutant basically.
True.
Like a human mutant or like a space mutant?
Titan mutant.
Killed his mom at birth.
Yeah, well,
he killed a lot of folks.
The problem that we're going to run into, at least in my prediction, is we're going to see a very different version of Thanos. That because of the popularity of the MCU, this is going to forever be the canon of Thanos, not the 50 years of comic book history and video games and cartoons and all the other stuff that we've seen Thanos is, and this will be Thanos for everybody going forward, so they better get it fucking right. I mean, more people are going to see this version than anything else.
You got to remember.
Death in there.
When has there been an 100% translation
not gonna be 100%
comic film
not gonna be 100%.
From any MCU?
I was going to say, Scott Pilgrim. Like,
this is going to be the MCU Thanos.
The first Spider-Man was pretty fucking close.
It was pretty close.
That was pretty fucking close.
No, I said the MCU.
Oh. You didn't? Well, you said.
I said MCU. I said in the MCU.
I mean, Cap was pretty damn close, too. Captain America is pretty close. Tony Stark, for the most part, they get right in the MCU.
I can tell what they got wrong. Spider-Man.
Yeah, I mean, Hulk, for the most part, even though the first one with...
Two?
You mean the the MCU is the Incredible Hulk.
Yeah, so the Incredible Hulk, for the most part, they got the gamma radiation, they got the sense of Hulk right. They did him better in Avengers than anything else, but they've gotten a lot... The majority of the characters they've gotten right. Here's the thing, too, that people fucking forget. Most people didn't give a single solitary fuck about Thor until the MCU came out.
Pull it back. Most people didn't give a fuck about Iron Man at the time because he was not... He wasn't like the top Marvel character.
Not anymore at the time. At the time, it was Spider-Man.
For certain. That's why I found Homecoming so goddamn disrespectful. But we've gotten into that.
Using that, basically with that, should we segue onto something that dropped yesterday?
What you got?
So we got a full trailer for the Venom movie.
Yes.
Yesterday, starring Tom Hardy, and we finally get
Hardy voice.
We see our first look at Venom in full Venom. Symbiotic or symbi... What do they say? No, they say symbi...
They say it funny in the trailer.
They say symbi...
Symbiotic.
Yeah, symbiotic. Some shit.
Wait, is it a female?
Yeah.
I didn't obey within this.
Yeah. Blue, what you got? You had some words on this.
Well, I saw the trailer yesterday, and... I mean, the preview they had before, they didn't ever show Venom. They just show Hardy. Or not Hardy.
Tom Hardy.
And... In the trailer, I actually did not like it. The end part was kind of cool when he does go full Venom, but like just the scenes where like, you know, the Venom is shooting out of his body and like stabbing people and like grabbing walls and stuff like that. Like, I didn't like that part too much, just because I know Venom can do that. I mean, that he does it in like the video games, but like, it just didn't seem right for some reason. Like, he didn't like. Maybe I'm just used to seeing him use webbing and stuff like that, but. Like
he uses the suit as like black shit too.
Yeah, but it just didn't look right. I mean, maybe I think what it is because Venom, when at least with Spider-Man, actually with Brock too, when he had the suit, is hit the Venom, the symbiotic, it can actually form clothing and stuff too. And I think that's the problem I've noticed with that, is that it doesn't seem like the clothes is the symbiotic. It seems like the thing is coming through his clothes. It's weird. That's
kind of quick.
It's the issue I had with the trailer, but it's just a trailer.
So, Prodigy.
Yes.
You got called out.
I did.
About your hatred or your discontent with Spider-Man Homecoming versus Venom, and how they're using kind of the same like retcon of an origin.
Yeah,
where's Tony Stark though? Is he in this movie?
Shit, he might come flying through, people talking suits and bullshit.
Yeah, this one's made by Sony.
Yeah, so let me address this real quick. First of all, I'm a Tom Hardy fan. I think he does pretty great in almost everything he's fucking in. So let me start with that by saying that usually I'll give Tom Hardy the benefit of the doubt. I'm all there on board with the fact that this is going to be, I guess, a Venom without Spider-Man, which from a comic book standpoint makes no sense why he would look that way, why he would have any beef with Spider-Man. I get all of that. My feeling from the, 60-second trailer was, this seems like an anti-hero monster movie, basically, where the Venom is almost like Punisher in terms of taking out bad guys. And I love the fact that you hear Venom's voice so prominently, like in him talking and then Eddie talking and then him saying "we." That part, like, not the origin of Venom, but the character itself from the actual trailer looked fun and quasi-comic accurate for how I've always read Venom in the comics.
So the thing about Venom is that his genesis is highly tied to Spider-Man.
It's all tied to Spider-Man.
And it's going to be, I mean, it's basically going to be this big black suit with no Spider-Man logo.
Which is wrong.
Possibly no webbing, maybe just tendrils coming out. And, you know, the symbiote basically trying to get revenge on Spidey. We may not even see that. I mean, there's rumors that Tom Holland will have a cameo for like maybe 30 seconds. There's rumors that Andrew Garfield may be Spider-Man in this for like 30 seconds.
Wow. But those are just rumors.
Those are just rumors. Yeah. We have nothing completely confirmed, but still, Venom without Spider-Man makes no sense.
I know there's different origin stories for a lot of these comic book characters, but for Venom, isn't he from space? Like, yeah. Or was he? So I know in the trailer they show him being created in the lab.
Go ahead, Kronos.
Well, I mean, the symbiote is from space, but not him. So, yeah. It's a Klyndar?
Mm-hmm. He's an alien.
Say the name. But yeah, it's an alien that needs another human, another host to basically do anything.
Okay. Yeah, because so, I mean, there is the, what was it? The what's that one storyline where the symbiotes like start taking over? There's like a symbiotic Thor and fucking.
Oh yeah. It's right now. It's Venomized, but they're called the Poisons.
It's
where they figure out how to weaponize the symbiote. So they give somebody a symbiote and then they'll have this poison thing basically invade their body and then it basically erases the host and the symbiote becomes a super powerful thing.
Yep. Yeah, but then back
fucking Thanos is one.
Yeah, yep. And then back in the day, is it Carnage Wars or whatever when the fucking babies start shooting out and there's a bunch of carnages everywhere? So Venom and Spidey have to team up to kill all the babies.
That's a great artwork.
Well, we don't know if we will possibly even see a Carnage in this.
I hope
we
so.
We might.
Oh man,
there's very possible that Carnage could be the bad in this movie
because Venom is the anti-hero in this, at least from the trailer.
But even
and we don't know.
There.
Yeah, and we don't know who the villain is.
See, this is another fucked up thing. When Venom first appears, he's instant villain.
Oh, of course.
Instant. This one, he's like, oh, well, we're gonna fuck people up, but we're gonna save the day just in a very crude manner. And all that shit you was talking about, where Daniel and Gian called you out, where you were pissed off about Homecoming, and
I'm still pissed off about that movie. Fuck
but
that.
But Daniel, you should be pissed off at this as well, but well, yet you're not.
Well,
you're,
hold on.
Tom Hardy, I'm gonna.
Hold the fuck on. Before Homecoming, I was one of the only motherfuckers pissed off about the Spider-Man introduction into the MCU in Civil War. That's where it fucking started with me, and everybody else was fucking sucking that dick because of the airport scene, and I was like, well, wait a minute.
No, not me.
Almost everybody was. And I was just like, wait a minute, when the fuck does Iron Man give Spider-Man his original suit? Now, regardless of all that, Venom is nowhere near as iconic as Spider-Man. They're not on the same level. They're not in the same league. They're nothing alike.
He's a support character.
Yeah. I mean, he's one of Spider-Man's villains. And I would say most people don't even think he's the best Spider-Man villain. Spider-Man has one of the best rogues galleries you're ever going to find.
See, that right there.
Second to Batman.
I feel like that is a panel question.
Panel question.
Yeah, okay. The best Spidey villain.
Oh, yeah.
Because that sounds like a very... I think a lot of people would have opinions about that.
You know what? We can do top a before five. And after on that because I think this Sony PS4 game is going to possibly... Because we haven't had a good Spider-Man game in years. That might change some people's opinions about who's a great Spidey villain, too.
Well,
who knows?
I don't even know who all of his... Like, back in the day, like, the Ultimate Spider-Man game, I think a shit ton of villains were in it.
Yes, this is true.
So this could be the same way. Where you face multiple villains. It may not be just one big bad.
Yeah, I'm sure there's going to be at least double digit.
Yeah.
With Spider-Man villains, the only ones, because I never were big into the comics, so I wasn't a big Marvel fan, but everything I know as far as Spider-Man goes is from the cartoons.
And he's had some great cartoons.
And games, too.
Yeah.
Some great cartoons and games.
So, I was going to say in Spider-Man Webs of Shadows or whatever I think it was called, the symbiotic suit starts attaching to other people, and there's a scene where Wolverine gets attacked by it, and then eventually there's Wolverine symbiotic things running around. Those things were fucking badass.
Hell yeah, man.
Yeah, so I still think that that's an interesting discussion that maybe we should.
We'll come back to it. We'll put a pin in it.
Well,
but I'm still saying, coming back to this movie, even though we see Venom, we don't know who his main villain is.
Yeah.
Like right now, he's hitting street level thugs. His villain could be Carnage, maybe Spider-Man, which
who knows?
I kind of doubt. We could possibly see some Sinister Sticks.
Yeah, you. I mean, Sony owns the rights to all the Spider-Man villains.
And they've been trying to do a Sinister Six with Andrew Garfield, so they could try to sneak that shit in. We just don't know.
To be honest with you, had Amazing Spider-Man 2 not been so god-awful with Jamie Foxx and all that bullshit, I would have been down to see more Garfield, you know, Spidey, Amazing Spidey, doing all kinds of fun stuff.
I actually didn't have a problem with Jamie Foxx's character. Yeah. I had a problem with fucking the Green Goblin guy. Mm. That guy is fucking annoying. Even in that movie with Riri.
Valerian.
That movie's fucking horrible because of him.
Valerian did suck, but it was beautiful to watch.
It was beautiful to watch.
So fucking gorgeous.
That guy was so fucking annoying. I hate that so much.
Watch that when you're high.
Yeah. Oh, dude, you'd be transported. But yeah, my biggest problem with Amazing Spider-Man 2 is that we've seen the Green Goblin in that form. We see Harry as a goblin twice.
Yes.
Twice.
Enough goblins.
We don't see Green Goblin like Norman Osborn. Like, you do see him in like after credit scenes, but it's not, it's just, it's not that. And then he dies, and I'm like, this is fucking stupid.
Kronos, why don't you get on in here with a little bit of promotional stuff?
All right, so this next portion of the podcast can be brought to you by Gamefly. Actually, this probably should have been the sponsor in the very beginning. We talked about God of War extensively. But yeah, so anyway, Gamefly is basically a monthly subscription service to where they send to you a game in the mail. It's if you don't like going and picking up your games from, you know, your local video game place, you're tired of speaking to sweaty nerds, this is your way to go, all right? Like I said, you pay a monthly fee, you make a list of the games that you want to play, and say you want to play, like, Wolfenstein 2, you get it, you play it, and then when you're done with it, you send it back, and they send you the next game that's on your list. It's a pretty great service. Say if you like a game a lot and you want to keep it, you can. They will charge you like a used game fee, and then they'll send you the box art and all that stuff, and you get to keep the game, and then they'll send you the next game that's on your list. It's pretty great. They also have, they have over 8,000 new and used games, and they have movies on Blu-ray and stuff as well, so it's a pretty great service.
Better than Netflix?
Better than Netflix. Like, oh, snap. Black Panther's coming out on May 15th. That's close.
Yeah, right.
Is it still in theaters?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, that's close. You already know we talked about God of War. I highly recommend you pick up that game. If you got a PS4 and you don't have God of War, there's something wrong with you. Mm-hmm. It actually makes me want to get a PS4 Pro and HDR, a 4K HDR TV to see what it's like on higher resolution. Because to be honest, in 1080p, it looks freaking amazing.
Yes. Melt your eyes.
Far Cry 5 is another game that most of us have played. It's a really good game. It's a first-person shooter. It's a lot of fun to play. So I beat that one. I made sure to beat that one before God of War came out. I cleared it out of my queue. What else is on? Oh, Wolfenstein 2 is coming to the Switch. Wow.
Switch is coming up on their games.
They are. Wow. They're really really getting down. And Dark Souls Remastered is coming out for the PS4. What other upcoming games are you guys looking forward to playing?
Shit.
Well, I already pre-ordered a Dark Souls. Spider-Man in September, but that's not coming for a little while.
Oh.
I know Stitch is going to be playing that MLB. The Show.
He gets it every year. So I'm on the fence about a game. I think it's out this week, or it might be already out. Was Detroit Being Human?
That's next month. Yeah. Next
is it
month.
Next month? Some people saying it's already out.
The demo is out right now.
Okay, that's what it was then. I'm interested in this game because there's only one game by them I don't think I've played, which was
Beyond Two Souls.
I played the demo, which starred Ellen Page.
Beyond Two Souls right now, or in the month of May, is going to be a PlayStation Plus free game.
Okay, yeah. So that game I'm cautiously anticipating. We'll see how Detroit Being Human is. I've seen a lot of videos of people playing the demo. In fact, IGN and I think GameSpot were doing, they were doing some live feed twitching of the game. So
let him finish there, goddammit.
Oh, I thought he was done. My bad.
No.
Let me throw a quick recommendation in there. I definitely recommend playing Don't Starve. It's an indie game, and it's a fun game, and the farther you go, the more creepier the game gets. I definitely highly recommend playing it with headphones on, because it will mess with your mind. It's so creepy.
All right, so if you go to gameflyoffer.com/BTI, you will get your first month of subscription service on us. That's right, a whole month free. Once again, that is gameflyoffer.com/BTI for your first month of subscription service for free. All right, now on with the show.
There we go.
Oh, wait, hold on.
Wait, go ahead.
That's perfect. Nice. That is perfect. B-O-I.
Before we go anywhere, I just want to say, I think I got my Batman card back.
Uh-oh, shit.
I finally finished playing Telltale's Batman Enemy Within. Holy shit. I don't know why it took me so long to play this goddamn game.
Yeah, it's, dude, it's fucking brilliant. I love
so
it.
So goddamn good. So in this game, like, you're basically the Joker's there, but he goes by the name of John, for short for John Smith, because nobody really knows his
John
name.
John Doe, I think.
Or John Doe, yeah. And you have, like, this weird relationship with him, like, because you meet him in this in Arkham, and you kind of have this friendship with him, but he kind of has, like, a little lead into, like, the underground world, and so you kind of befriend him to try to get information and stuff like that. But it's so fucked up because everything kind of goes sideways towards the end. It's... The game is so good, and I really like the way they portray Harley Quinn in this, because instead of her being the Joker's, like, sidekick, she's kind of the badass boss in this, and the Joker's her fucking sidekick, which is kind of cool. And she's fucking, like, push him around and shit like that, and it's such a great game, and, like, the story is totally not what you see in the comic books, which is kind of cool. But one of the hardest things about this whole entire fucking game is that, I said it before, the first one, is that if you think you can be Batman, this game will kick you in the fucking teeth and say, no, you can't. Not.
Yep.
Because every decision you make have, like, consequences, and some of them are good and some of them are bad.
Like, I'm a shitty decision maker. I both fucked Catwoman and then fucked her over. That's what I did on that game. So she does not want to fuck with me ever a fucking again. So, and there are...
But you got the pussies, right?
I did get that pussies. Yeah, that pussies was good. But I will say this, too. There are iconic Batman characters that you already fucking know that will die.
Yes.
And there ain't shit you can do about it, but live with them consequences. The way I play Telltale games, I never go back and replay them. I'm like, whatever fucked up decision I made the first time, that's the fucked up life for this character.
Yeah, me too. Because, yeah. Well, one cool thing is that with one of the villains... Like, so the Riddler's in this, and he fucking dies. I mean, spoiler, sorry, but the compass for the game. He's the reason why the game is going on. The catalyst, yeah. And just the fact that he dies is like, holy shit, like, he's like a villain. Like, how is he dying in this fucking game? Like, a bad guy died. Like, it's so crazy because, like, a lot of people fucking die in this game, and they're not coming back. It's kind of cool. But it's
Speed Racer. If people die, don't come back.
Yeah.
But yeah, this game is so much fun. It's like only $25, and you get like, it's five seasons or five episodes.
Yeah, five episodes. This is the second season. I say play through one, obviously, go in order. And
I think one is free right now. You can play one for free.
Yeah,
I believe you're right. And then you can pay for the other ones. But every game or every episode is about maybe hour and a half, 2 hours play time, depending on your gameplay. Yeah. But it's. The ending to this game, it takes everything that you've done and, like, it changed the ending of the game. Like, either you can kind of still be friends with the Joker, or you can just be fucking mortal enemies, which is kind of crazy.
I amazingly got every villain and every side character that's supposed to be an ally to hate both Bruce and Batman.
God damn. You fucked up.
Yes, I'm telling you. Shitty decision maker.
Dude, like, I felt all bad when I kind of betrayed Gordon and started to hang out with Amanda Waller, and I know she's up to no fucking good just based off of, so you can't take what you know about these characters from the comics because the shit's not true. Like, for example, like John Doe or the Joker, like, you know he's a fucking Joker. Like, he does Joker, like, he's always constantly, like, laughing and shit, like, out loud, so you're always, like, kind of like, okay, he's got the fucking turn, this is all just a fucking trick and this and that and this and that, but it's mainly your decisions that caused him to go either crazy Joker or, like, fucking your friend Joker. So it's like, it's crazy. It's a great fucking game. I love how they do these games.
Well written. Good shit. All right, let's
wait. Do I have my Batman card back?
No, fuck you. You can temporarily have that bullshit. What do you want to get into?
Can we talk about this? Because we're actually getting a few questions about
what
this.
What we got?
This fan con cancellation.
Ooh. Boy.
What was going on with this?
So I guess I was trying to read quickly this afternoon a little bit, but Twitter blew up over the weekend about it. I guess it's a Baltimore-based convention that was going to be for a full weekend where it was funded by Kickstarter. Stop me if I'm saying something that's inaccurate or whatever on here. I think they got up to about, what did I write down here? 50, something like 50,000 in terms of Kickstarter funds. People had like taken time off of work. People had booked their hotel rooms, all that stuff, given money.
Yeah, they got 56,498.
There you go. And this shit got postponed indefinitely.
Yeah,
due to some money shit.
It's supposed to be the April 27th through the 29th
this weekend.
Yep. And it just got canceled like last week is when this shit went down. So people were fucking pissed, rightly so, because they paid their hard-earned money and they talking some bullshit about this shit got canceled. Whoever fucking organized it, I can't remember the fucking names or whatever, but they fucked up. And it sounds like one of the key organizers had a long history of doing this kind of bullshit in terms of, like, psych, I got your money, and peace out.
Was Ja Rule behind this?
Yeah. Sound like it, man. I feel for the victims, though, in terms of, like,
dude, that's...
you know, we go to a lot of fucking cons. Imagine, I mean, we don't always pay for them, but imagine, like, paying for them, and then, like, you know, people be like, peace out. Fuck your money. What the fuck? Some people, I think, are maybe getting refunds now, maybe, but don't even quote me on that. Maybe not everybody's gotten their fucking money back. Y'all furiously reading while we're trying to report on it. What we got?
Yeah, I'm looking at this stuff. How much
did I say anything completely inaccurate?
56,000
so far
it looks pretty accurate. I mean, it sucks because it looks like, you know, I mean, when a con comes in or any kind of convention, whether it be, you know, whatever, everything that's around gains business, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no
so,
shit.
Hotels lose lodging. Restaurants don't get, like, their rushes of people that would come in. You know, other attractions.
But
that
you get new people. You get the people who are attending the con.
All that money's gone. That's increased revenue for all these folks, and now that's all gone. Like, they were anticipating, you know, these groups of people coming in, and then there's nothing.
What was their Kickstarter goal?
$25,000. So they doubled it.
Somebody stole their money. Yep. That's what happened right there. Somebody stole their money.
Yep.
And that's fucked up. I mean, because obviously, like, if you have a Kickstarter goal and your goal is X amount of money, that's your budget, right? So that means that's your base budget. And when you go more than double that, that means somebody stole your fucking money.
Mm-hmm.
There's no fucking way that you write out an entire fucking budget and then you get more than double that and all of a sudden you don't have funds to fucking put on what you said you were going to put on. That's total bullshit.
I'm trying to see what they said was the reason why they canceled it.
Wow. It was basically they said they didn't have enough funding because they were setting up floor plans and everything. They didn't have enough financial backing.
They should give everybody back their fucking money.
And some of the stars they had set up were, like, they had Makad Brooks, who plays James Olsen on Supergirl, Orlando Jones, Billy Dee Williams, Big Daddy Kane.
Big Daddy Kane.
He's still alive?
Yeah. Slaying them things.
Yeah, they were all slated to show up.
I feel for the people who paid their money. I hope everybody gets their fucking refunds, but it also seems like a big lesson of not everybody knows how to organize a con.
Yeah.
You know, not everybody is, like, in your best interest.
Well, it just goes to show, just in general, with Kickstarters and stuff like that. Like, all these crowdfunding sites, they're fucking sketchy, man. I mean, you know, I've done a couple of, you know, crowdfunding things, and, you know, one went really well. My wallet, that went well.
Oh,
you know,
yeah.
Everything was on time. They gave us timely updates. It was great. One that didn't go so well, but I did get the product, was a Switch Charge.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that part of the problem is with, like, a lot of these people that do these crowdfunding things, especially that when they call themselves businesses, is they think the people that are giving money to these crowdfundings are investors. They are not fucking investors. All right? When you're part of a crowdfunding thing, they're getting it for a product. They're not fucking investors. All right? They're not putting in fucking shares or some shit like that. They're not buying in part of your company. They want a fucking product that you're going to provide at the end of this fucking campaign.
Mm.
And I think that's where a lot of those businesses kind of lose their shit, because they think that, oh, people are giving me their money so now I can do whatever the fuck I want with it. No. You need to do what you fucking said in your campaign. You need to uphold to those things. And I think that there really needs to be a better oversight with Kickstarter and Indiegogo and all the rest of these fucking of these crowdfunding sites. There's been way too many of these crowdfunding disasters that I've seen. Like, one of the greatest ones that I saw was Scully. And I was so close to investing in Scully. At the time, I had money to invest in it. To buy the product.
Tell people what Scully is.
Scully was, it's a helmet that had augmented reality in the helmet. And they could see behind you. You bring up GPS directions in your helmet and shit like that.
Speed, everything. It's everything. It was basically a hub.
Yeah. But basically, they raised, I think, over $1 million. I think it was like $2 million.
Yeah, they raised a lot of fucking money.
And they folded last year.
Wow.
But this year,
I thought they were back.
They are back because they're releasing a new product called the Phoenix. That's supposed to be released in. There's no crowdfunding, so you're just gonna buy it. And supposedly it's basically the same thing, but it has a carbon fiber shell. It's like $1,800.
Yeah.
And it's supposed to release in summer of 2018. But anyway, yeah, I think that there needs to be better oversight with these crowdfunding sites. To really have consequences for when people basically steal money like this.
Yeah.
This is pretty fucked up. I'm sure there's going to be people that are probably not going to get their money back. That's fucked
sad.
Up.
That's super sad.
Well, yeah, I'm actually reading, like, several different people who invested in this and are either not going to get their money back or going to get a fraction of their money back.
Well, hold on, I got to look it up. Because when I read the thing, I'll tell you exactly where they fucked up. Because this is why I hate doing reading these things. They say they're investors, but they're not. It's not an investment if you're getting a product.
Yeah.
That's not how investments work. You know?
That's a purchase.
Yeah, so if it's a purchase where it says, I'm going to get X for X, then that's not an investment.
Yeah. Man, I hate
it. It's like a down payment or a letaway.
It seems like there was some predatory shit, again, on people who love to go to cons. We're people who love to go to fucking cons. You know what I mean? I feel for those folks, but man, ugly shit. Especially people taking time off of work, ready to do it, ready to have fun and see some celebrities, go to some panels, well, do
even,
all that.
Even people who are traveling to get to this location,
yeah,
too.
There's people who bought plane tickets, paid for a hotel, and bought tickets.
Can I just say, too, it also shows that, like, some of the big cons, WonderCon, New York Comic Con, you know, San Diego Comic Con and shit, they are run like well-oiled fucking machines.
So remember, you gotta give credit. They started out back in the day. They had their bumps in the road. They started small and grew, but they're all run under the same banner.
Well, not New York. Not New York. San Diego
New York
and Wonder.
Comic-Con,
yeah. San Diego and Wonder are under the same.
I'm pretty sure they're on the New York might be too.
Mm. Yeah, these are all it's a product. These are all things that they're selling. Like it's not an investment. So when they say, you know, pledge $100 or more and you get this, you're expecting a product.
Yeah.
That is
yeah.
not investment. When you invest in something, you're giving your money to support, you know, and hoping that you'll make money back.
Yeah.
Return
you know what I mean?
On investment.
Exactly. That's not what you're getting here. You're buying some sort of product or service.
Yeah.
And that's what they were selling. They weren't saying, hey, you know, invest in us so we can get this going. You're expecting something in return.
This is some Ja Rule shit. I think that there's a lot of parallels you can make with the Ja Rule bullshit with that boat a couple months back.
Fucking party for rich people.
Yeah, so. Again, heart goes out to folks. You know what I mean? If we ever throw a motherfucking con, y'all can best believe we're going to bring it to realness.
There'll be malt liquor for everybody.
And chicken wings.
Coke 47.
I have some ideas about like something that we could do, but we have to have a lot of money.
There you go.
Are we done with the subject?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I ain't got shit else on that.
It's kind of depressing, so.
So I went to go, me and K-Mac, we went to a Justin Timberlake concert last night.
Mr. JT.
I got to say, it's pretty fucking amazing.
Really?
It's pretty fucking amazing, and I had kind of epiphany. I'll talk about that in a minute. But yeah, like he's a pretty good showman. Like I was pretty amazed. Like he actually sings, he fucking dances a lot, sweating like a motherfucker.
Good.
He brought out his whole the Tennessee Kids band. It's a huge fucking band.
I don't know who are the Tennessee Kids.
So basically it's like who does his music now. Like when he goes live, it's like his backup dancer is like
that the name
ensemble.
Of the group?
Yes,
the
group.
Oh, okay.
It's a full ensemble fucking band. They got drummers, fucking guitarists, all kinds of shit.
It's almost like, you know how like in old 80s movies, how they're old Blue Eyes would be performing on stage and he has like the band in the back and they're all like kind of stacked up. That's basically what the what same guys are. But
yeah, it was really cool. So it was in the SAP Center. So it's basically an arena. And if y'all have ever been like an arena before that houses like normal like sports events, usually what they do is they have like the arena, but on, you know, the backside will be blocked off. So you can only see like one side of the stage. But the way they did on this one is fucking genius. Basically, the whole middle was like this whole like elaborate fucking stage. So they had like a main stage up top, like kind of in the back, but there's still people behind him. And then there was like this like elaborate fucking like stage that snaked around like through the crowd.
Oh shit!
That had like shit on, like had like trees because it's called like the Man in the Woods.
Is that his new album or something?
Yeah.
Okay.
And so, but the stage like did stuff. Like partway through like the show, like the actual entire stage that was like facing towards like what would be the front turned around so. everybody can see, like, the whole band and Justin Timberlake.
Okay.
As he was doing his thing. And, like, he would actually walk around down in, like, the crowd, like, on the stage and shit.
Pissing on people?
It's really fucking cool, yeah. But it was, and there's, like, in the beginning, it was, like, huge, like, laser light show and shit. And
yeah.
It was fucking dope. Oh, and they had, like, these fucking, like, translucent fucking, like,
dildos?
Screens?
No. There's, like, screens, yeah. But there was, like, they weren't even, like, screens. It was almost like curtains that came down.
Yeah.
And it displayed fucking, but you can see through it, right?
Okay.
And it would display, like, what was going on the stage and, like, other, like, really cool, like, graphics and stuff. It was
porn?
Fucking amazing. Not a porn.
I'm sorry.
They kept it clean for the kids, though. Sort of.
Grinding?
But yeah, it was, like in like, parts of the stage would, like, transform.
Oh, shit.
Like, okay. One time they were, like, walking around and all of a sudden there was grass on the stage where, like, it wasn't before. And I was like, what the fuck?
I was like, that's, you know, how you throw grass?
Awesome. Yeah. What were you gonna say?
When I was gonna say, I've seen Justin perform before too, and when I went to go see him one time, like, so, like, say we're all looking one direction towards the stage where he's mainly performing, but what's fucking cool, this goddamn stage rolls in the fucking air, and there's people on the ground, like, in the front row. It rolls up and fucking moved to the other side of the fucking arena, and then, like, he was up there dancing for everybody on this side of the arena. It was fucking dope.
That's a transformer.
Yeah, basically.
He does a really cool job of, like, bait and switch. Like, watch over here as we change something over there.
Oh, shit.
You know what I mean? So it's pretty dope.
Yeah.
And, like, one of my favorite parts about the whole show is they had, like, they had this part where they literally brought out a fucking campfire. Like, it was literal fire.
What the fuck?
And so, like, he gets around with, like, parts of his band, and he starts singing, like, one of his songs. Like, they're doing, like, a campfire thing. Mm-hmm. And then he goes, you know, this is the part of the time, you know, the show where I'm going to, you know, put on display, like, some of the band members. And so we'll have, like, he had three of his backup singers sing, like various songs.
Nice.
Like, and it was, like, really cool. It was, like being around a campfire. And they even had, like, a guy with, like, a shitty fucking camcorder, like, videotaping everybody, but then it would show up on that fucking translucent screen.
Okay.
It looked like it was, like, old school, like, film and shit. So it was, like, it was fucking cool, you know?
Can I ask you this, though? So it sounds like the theme was his newer album.
Yeah.
I'm assuming that he went back and played his hits, right?
Okay. Yeah, he went back and he went through, like, pretty extensive. He's got a long catalog now, so. He played, like, his hits, and everybody, you know, blew up for his hits. And his new stuff, there's some stuff. Yeah, I didn't listen to his new album yet, so I listened to, like, a couple songs, but not the whole thing.
Okay, good
shit. But yeah, I mean, this guy's a showman. And I fucking figured it out.
What?
I sort of figured it out. Why I don't have a problem with cultural appropriation for the most part.
Okay.
All right, so we sat down. Me and Kamek sat down. And in front of us, there were these two large heifarillas. Right?
There
were some large ladies. And they were, I don't know, they were weird. But, like, they were, like, some songs came on that were, like, rap songs. And they were like, oh, you know, blah, blah. And it was, like, I was, like, it was annoying to me.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, well, why the fuck is that annoying to me? Is it annoying because they're white and they're, like, trying to talk like they know this music or what? And I was, like, trying to just break it down for a little while. And because I was like, oh, you know, well, if, like, say if, like, a Kendrick Lamar song came on, like, say if Fear came on,
mm-hmm.
like, it's annoying to me if, like, if somebody that isn't black was like, oh, yeah, that's my jam. Because you would have no idea, to me, you would have no idea what that song is really about because you didn't live that experience. So from that point of view, that's when I was like, oh, I sort of get now what people have a problem with cultural appropriation. Sort of.
But I was just going to say, I mean, because obviously I've grown up with you. I know you.
Yeah.
And obviously even the audience knows you. You have listened to metal for over 20 fucking years.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know, and so, and it's one of your favorite genres.
Yes.
So when we flip that, it's obviously I don't have a problem with that.
Oh, yeah, yeah, for sure, yeah. For sure. That's why I said it's just annoying. I'm not going to say don't do it.
Okay.
But I can still understand because I think that they're going to be missing. Why it would be annoying to me is because you're going to be not picking up on certain cues that I'll pick up for, like, certain songs. Like,
okay.
Fear is probably, like, one of the better ones, examples.
That could start a good dialogue, though. It could make you go into, you know, into Compton and learn some things.
But then, you know, Justin Timberlake came on, and I was like, why do I have zero problems with him?
There you go.
Doing his thing. And then I realized the reason why is because, in my opinion, he has not only done his research, but he's actually, like, heavily influenced by other black artists. So when he really blew up was when he left NSYNC and he got with Timbaland, right? And so that's when he really blew up.
As a solo, yeah.
Yeah, and I think he drew heavy influences from him, and he also pays homage to who influenced him. Like, he's not gonna, like, say, oh, this is all my shit. Like, he'll say who his influences were, and he gives back to, like, his band. Like, when he sat down, like, around the campfire with his band, like, obviously, most of them were black. Most of his band is black.
Yeah.
And so for him to, like, you know, not trying to pretend that, you know, this is all just him making all this shit, but it's through influences from a different culture that he not only was influenced by, but regularly interacts with.
Yeah.
I think that's one of the main reasons why most people in general don't have a problem with Justin Timberlake doing his thing, but for some reason Bruno Mars, which I don't get either, because he does the same thing.
Yeah, he gets props to artists yeah. that you're influenced by.
Bruno exactly. Mars is closer to black than Justin Timberlake.
Yeah, yeah. That's no, well, not really.
Well, he's not black at all.
Yeah, yeah, but I mean, neither is Justin Timberlake. Yeah.
Doesn't he have Puerto Rican and Filipino? I don't know.
Yeah, I think that's what he is.
It doesn't matter. But I'm just saying is that I think I just realized that why generally what like a lot of artists I don't have a problem with, quote unquote cultural appropriations, because most artists actually do recognize that they're getting their influences from a different culture, but they also pay homage to those cultures. I think I don't really have a problem, but it's just weird to me when somebody does that and they have no idea like the cultural significance of what they're doing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's why I hate these fucking new rappers, because they're trying to build upon this shit and like not even giving any sort of due to like the previous generation that gave them a platform to be where they're at now. First of all, they're shit rappers.
No.
Most of them. In my opinion, yeah. I'll leave it at that. My opinion, most of the new generation are shit rappers. And I think part of the problem is that they don't really want to recognize the previous generation at all. You know, that they drew influences from.
Wow. I think a lot of the cultural appropriation comes from this is mine or from my people, you have no right to be doing what we are doing or what we've been known to be doing. Mm. And I think a lot of people try to put their claim on it, like, you know, oh, this belongs to us, you shouldn't be doing this, especially if they're doing it semi-decent. And a lot of people kind of get up in arms about it. And I'm like, well, one, from a musician standpoint, you're doing what you probably grew up on. It's what you know. You probably grew up on this type of flavor of music. You want to play homage to it because this is what you want to do. This is what you were about. This is maybe all you know. Mm. And other people may not understand that. I mean, don't get me wrong. There will be some artists that are like, okay, this is what's new and hot. You know, and it's not really an artist at all. Sometimes it's just like a record label. They're like, we want this kind of artist. We need an artist to cover this genre. You are it. So go out there, make this kind of music, and then make us our money.
There.
I think a perfect example is Pink. When Pink came out, she was on that R&B tip.
Yes, she was.
And she explicitly states in her later music that she did not want to do that. She wanted to be her own spirit, her own artist, make her own music, and they forced her to do this R&B thing.
Luckily, she's now, yeah.
And so now she does, like, mainly kind of rockish, maybe a little alternative a bit. I mean, there's a little bit of R&B flavor, but it's still kind of her flavor, you know?
Yeah. You actually brought up a good point earlier when you said, like, me listening to metal and the cultural significance of this shit.
Mm-hmm.
That's totally true. Obviously, it goes both ways, right? But for me, so when I started listening to metal, I'll give, like, Metallica as a small example. There was probably some stuff that I was missing, but I did research on the band to figure out what some of that shit was. Like, I didn't know, like, when I first started listening to Metallica that, you know, James Hetfield grew up in a really religious household, and that really influenced a lot of his songs.
Yep.
And so that's why I think as long as you understand, or at least make an attempt to understand what that culture is all about, not just, like, take it and, like, not really understand what the fuck is going on. Yeah, I think that's where people kind of get pissed. But I also think, you know me, a lot of people claim cultural appropriation, like, way too quick. Like, you have no idea if this person has done their due diligence on, like, trying to learn that culture or whatever. And also, you don't have to learn, like, every single fucking fact about a culture to appreciate it.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
There we go.
Speaking of which, Crunch, are you watching this Netflix show, Agretzko?
No.
It's live action anime.
No,
what are we talking?
It's Foodus? Anime.
Foodus?
No, it's basically Hello Kitty. It's basically Hello Kitty works in an office, and she takes out her frustration by doing metal at karaoke.
It's a panda.
Is she a panda? It looks like a cat. No, it's a, she looks like a goddamn. She looks like Hello Kitty.
It's supposed to be a panda.
Yeah, and it's funny to me because when they promoted it, they promoted it in English. Mm-hmm. And when you watch it, it's actually Japanese sub.
For if it's on Netflix, they probably have both options.
Yeah, they do. So when you watch it, I actually watch it English dubbed, but it still has Japanese subtitles or English subtitles, and like what they translated is not exactly the same, and it's pretty. It makes it even more fucking funny.
Yeah, Crazy Cat Lady actually posted on our Facebook page about it, and I didn't even hear about it, but I'm all in.
I saw a commercial. I've seen, so each episode's 15 minutes.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm definitely watching.
I saw the first episode, so I watched it in Japanese. Reading the subtitles, it's not that funny. Listening in English, it's fucking hilarious.
I don't understand what you just
said. Holy shit.
If Japanese and subtitles is an option, why the fuck would I listen to it in English?
Dude, do this. Watch the first 3 minutes, and when you're listening in Japanese, it doesn't come off as funny. Even reading it, it's just like,
context.
It is. There's a lot of content, and it seems more super formal. When you're watching it in like English dubbed, it's fucking hilarious. Hmm. It's like, okay, I can kind of identify more because they kind of change it to be like the like Office Space kind of thing.
Humor can be very culture specific at times. But,
it is.
But some things are universal.
So it's pretty funny. It's funny because she's like in this, like, you know, taking out her rage in doing metal at karaoke, and people like come in and they're like, you ordered food. And she looks at them like death eyes. She's like, just set it over there. It's pretty fucking funny.
I'm going to watch that too. Let's stick with anime. Everybody what? Current just, on. Hold on, motherfucker.
I was going to jump here. season 1 of Black Lightning is on Netflix now.
Oh, that's wow. Quick.
Okay.
Yeah. It's really quick.
I thought the show hadn't finished.
No, it's over. It finished last week.
Oh. Wow, that's quick.
But yeah, it's on Netflix.
I'm catching up, so I watched like 2 hours.
I finished it.
All right, I'll watch it. I'll slam through it on Netflix. But staying on anime real quick, is everybody current on my Waifu 02, darling, in the
Friends? Yeah, I am.
See, I'm 2 episodes in, and I'm like, holy shit. I was 2 episodes in, but then I started to kill God, so.
Six of everything.
Life stopped.
So then if you're only 2 episodes in, we're not going to spoil it, but holy shit, the ending was just
fucking. Was that the finale?
It felt like it.
I don't think it was.
Wait. Did was there?
I hope not. Was it?
Did you see a final form of Strelizia or whatever?
Yeah.
To me, it felt like a finale, but I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe the saga continues. I want more episodes.
What episode are you on?
15 or something like that.
That seems kind of short for.
Maybe I'm wrong.
But no, then again, some of them are 12. Like I think Attack on Titan is only 12 episodes.
Yeah, I don't know. So Kronos is looking it up, but I tell you what, if you ain't got what 02 and Hero got,
there will be 24 episodes.
Oh, 24. Okay, good.
Okay.
It felt like almost the endish, but yeah, that's
good. No, I felt like there was some shit to do.
Well, yeah, I don't know. I got credit. Anyway, it had an emotional connection with me. I'll say that.
Which one were we on? What number was it?
I thought it was 15 or something, right? I thought the one that they just aired. Maybe I'm tripping.
Oh, that's the soundtrack. Oh.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, it says, okay, that was 15, but they said there's going to be 24 total, so.
Okay, then that's good. Really good. That almost sounds like two seasons stacked on top of each other.
I guess we'll find out on the 28th when the next one airs.
There you go.
Finale or not. Or maybe it'll be like a new season, because a lot of shows in Japan, they don't really have seasons. They just kind of roll into the next one without you even knowing.
There's more mysteries to solve, definitely.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Because I want to know what that big-ass hand was. I'm just saying.
Yeah, well, and you don't even know all of the backstory with the council.
Yeah, you know? They seem real fucking shady.
Yep.
And I'm pretty sure that Core was a person.
Yep.
So, yeah.
But that darling, though.
My darling.
Darling. I love the way she said it. This is good shit.
Westworld Season 2. Any of y'all watch it?
I didn't watch it.
I haven't watched it yet.
Y'all killing gods?
Killing gods, man.
I take a break for Westworld and The Expanse.
Ah, right. Son of a bitch.
Did you watch Into the Badlands yet?
No. It's them gods, though.
Yeah, dude.
Let's stay with TV just a little bit. I think Blue is probably the only one that watched like 11 episodes of 20 years of Smallville.
Oh, yes.
I watched a lot too.
Oh, you did watch? Okay.
Yeah. It was
what
a good show.
What the fuck is going on with Allison Mack and a sex cult?
The best question I have to ask is, A, was everybody of age?
It sounds like they were.
Okay, yeah.
And then B, did anybody get hurt?
I mean,
if
it sounds like there was some physical damage of people getting branded, but then if you're in a
willing,
that's my thing though. Yeah, I'm like, with you on that.
Kink, oh. I don't really give a fuck.
Well, yeah.
Well, I mean, like they were kind of, they weren't being forced into having sex, but they were kind of. It's almost in that gray area, but not really.
She's being charged with recruiting people into a sex cult and sex trafficking,
yeah.
and again of adults and having to have sex with this cult leader. Well, okay, in exchange so for
if
shit.
It's against your will, then yeah, obviously there's problems. But if it's if everybody was like, okay, let's do it, then I don't see a problem.
Yeah,
I really don't.
I'm with you.
Yeah.
So yeah, with the cult, if everyone's consenting, yes. But if their sex trafficking is an offense, which is illegal, so
I guess I just need details.
Yeah. So
like what they consider sex trafficking, because I know in S&M fucking circles, you can let somebody borrow.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, slave. Yes, your slave. Yeah.
This is true, but I think the sex trafficking by the FBI is probably very specific, and I believe that they may have done some other stuff that's illegal as well.
Yeah, these are just charges for right now. All I know is it being associated with a star of, like, you know, a TV show that people watch for 50, 11 goddamn years. That show was on for 10 years or something.
Yeah, it was
right?
on for 10 years. What's crazy about it is that, like, she seemed like a square, like, kind of like an easygoing person. Like, she seemed very nice and stuff like that. But, like, her getting into this all together started off with her co-worker, Kristen Kreuk. Actually,
she's fucking hot. She's
on Smallville?
On Smallville, too, yeah. She played Lana Lang. And
She is bad.
So this whole thing was supposed to be like a woman's self-help group that just somehow went astray. Which I don't know how it goes from a woman help group to you're serving a man and your only goal is to please him, basically.
Mm. Yeah, she's pretty.
Kristen Kreuk.
Where is she now? Why isn't she in stuff?
Well, she's
getting
on
a sex cult.
She's on a CDW show called Beauty and the Beast for a bit.
That was like a mini series.
Still kind of going on. I don't know.
That ended. I thought that was like a little mini series type thing.
They went on for a couple of
seasons. She mixed Asian and white or something.
Mixed with fine and fine. I'll tell you that.
I think she's like Dutch. She's like Asian and Dutch.
Yeah, she's bad.
I looked her up.
Oh, she's Canadian. What's that about?
Yeah. So
she was Chun Li in the movie was so bad.
So it looks like there's charges from conspiracy to commit forced labor to sex trafficking.
Oh, so they were hoeing. Probably for as the forced labor. Maybe.
I think only to the master, the main guy.
God damn.
Yeah, the guy of the group, Keith Rainier. He's being charged, and I guess she's being charged as basically a co-conspirator.
Yeah, I mean,
because she was basically a top lieutenant.
Isn't that show in syndication? Like, aren't you? It's not in syndication.
I don't know.
Smallville? No, it was on Netflix. Like every single season was on there. I don't know if it's on there.
I have season 1 through 8 at home. DVD versions.
I will say this: if fucking Dean Cain from Lois and Clark had been caught up in this kind of shit, it'd be a different type of anger and rage from the fucking public. I will tell you that now. Mm-hmm. This girl got a cute little face, and people remember her fondly from the show. And people are like, "Well, maybe she didn't. Maybe she was a victim too."
The crazy thing is that they keep talking about Smallville, but Smallville was on like probably like 10 years ago. It was the longest fucking time when this show ended.
Well, didn't you say? Well, you know that Kristen Kreuk was part of this group.
Yeah, she was. So, but she wasn't part of the sex trafficking part. No, she was only there for the woman's help part.
So apparently, when they're on Smallville, they joined this group.
Yeah, they were on the show when it started.
When it started, some but weird Kirsten, shit. Kristen Kreuk had left years ago, and then Allison Mack stayed with the group. So there was branding.
I need more details, though. Again, if you're over 18 and you say, I want to be fucking fucked 6 ways from Sunday and brand me and spray that cum daddy, that's on you, right?
I'll have your baby. But
this
is
America.
But if you're doing forced labor... and like recruiting people illegally.
It depends though. Yeah. I'm just saying. There's a lot of shit that.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, never been to a dungeon or some shit.
I know Ginz goes in there.
But I say, hey, you can go on kink.com right now. You see some real fucked up shit that everybody said yes to.
If you ever want to see somebody's soul, go to kink.com.
So I mean, I think if there was like, I mean. if there's a court docket available or whatnot for the public to see, there might be some horrendous shit involved.
I need these details.
Like I said, it could be horrendous, but it depends on the person. Mm-hmm. Like if they said no and meant no, then yeah, it's fucked up. Yeah. But if they give consent, I don't really see a problem.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of crazy about this. This has actually been going on for a while, probably a couple of years that this report's been brought up.
I heard about it a long time ago.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So the fact that, and because the guy was arrested a while back, and I guess now she was arrested. But.
Yeah, she's arrested as co-conspirator.
Wow. Also, Kristen Kurek, however you say her last name, yeah. She is Dutch and Chinese. She's actually Dutch and Chinese Jamaican. That's fucking weird, isn't
what
it?
The fuck? Wow.
She's Jamaican. Her grandmother was Chinese Jamaican.
She's bad. I know that. Bad as fuck. I need to see her
more.
Just
mean that she got that dog on her from back in
the day? There we go. Should we do any B than BCIs? I know I saw some.
Yeah, we had the one about the fan con, whatever, that fucking debacle.
Oh, yeah, we did talk. We discussed that in detail. Hopefully that was informative.
No, but we have a specific question.
We have one.
So, what would we name, if we had a con, what would we name it?
The Dank Con?
Yeah, or Titty Meat Spectacular.
TNA.
It's for the children.
We can't name it the King Queen of Spades Con. We might get the wrong crowd.
Oh, will we?
Or the right crowd.
Or the right crowd. Oh.
We'll call it Future Con.
Yeah, just make sure you sign the release form. That's the same.
We're not a sex cult.
So we have a question from Jerome
Butler?
Pew. So this person says, I lost 1,000 planning for this con.
Oh,
I don't attend cons regularly. How can I avoid this in the future?
Kronos, you want to?
Well, I kind of already went over it. I mean, it's just like, I've never seen a single other con do a fucking crowdfunding. Because normally you get funding through like sponsors and actual investors, not your actual
fans,
your revenue stream.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like you don't go through your revenue stream to do something like that.
And you just buy a regular ticket.
Yeah. Well, that's what it was. That's what's weird is that look, if you should already secured funding for the event, and then basically when you sell tickets, that's how you get your money back and make profit.
Yep.
Like, that should have already been done on the backside. So I guess in the future is don't do something like this again. Like, you shouldn't be, I don't know how can I put it? Like, would you do a GoFundMe for like an artist? You know what I mean? Like, go to like one of their concerts? Yeah. Like, why wouldn't you just buy a ticket?
Well,
you know?
There are for comic artists, you know? Plenty of GoFundMe or Kickstarters.
Go to like their concerts, you know what I mean? That'd be fucking weird. It's like you should have already secured, like if an artist said, I need money to secure a venue and to do all this blah, 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 I'd be like, no.
Yeah.
Like, get your shit together, get the venue together, then I'll buy a ticket. But I don't want to be a part of the process of me trying to fund you to secure your shit.
I'll say this, because this is so high profile, this is still a big fucking story and shit. I feel like there's going to be some type of legal action one way or another.
Yeah,
and so
sure.
I would say for James that asked us the question, Jerome, you need to be a part of whatever class legal action is going down for that refund.
Yeah.
You know, pain and repercussions.
That was not a lie. I'll tell you what, I went through some of this. It wasn't through crowdfunding, but you know, with my adoption stuff, I just wrote it off as a fucking loss, to be honest with you.
Yeah, damn.
You're likely not going to get the money back. To be honest, like if they're broke, because somebody probably spent the money, to be honest with you. Because if they went double over what they're asking for, that doesn't make any fucking sense to anybody that knows any kind of basic math on how you can go double over and still not have enough money and then somehow not be able to pay the money back to the people that bought their shit. That doesn't make any fucking sense. Like, where did the money go?
And I'm going to double down on this too. All the organizers shouldn't be involved in any cons nationwide ever. Like, when you see that name associated with it, everybody's ears should perk up. Everybody should be like, no, fuck you.
There should be a no work to this person list. Like,
literally, you're banned from every con that we can imagine. Wizard World, Comic Con, everything. We don't need to see your ass. You ain't invited to the cookout.
Well, that's hard to say because, like, a lot of people have the same name.
Find out who it is.
Hey, Jerome, I'll tell you this. If you, $1,000 is a lot of money for the vast majority of people.
What came with that pledge? Like, was it like a blowjob?
Well, no. So
there were tears.
Let him say it.
Well, he had asked the question.
He's going to keep coming up, though.
All right. This is what we do.
Look, You likely lost $1,000. All right. But what we can do to help you is if you put together, I know this is going to sound weird, but if you put together a GoFundMe page to recoup your exact $1,000, we will promote it.
There we go. I like that. Look at us helping people.
Yeah. We'll promote it and we'll get it out to other people that can promote it just so you can get your money back.
But if, if it goes over $1,000, the other money's ours. We're taking off the top.
It'll be exactly $1,000 and then you cut it off.
All right? There you go.
Don't be fucking greedy. I'll be talking shit about you next.
You know what, though? I like that, though. That's a great. Let's follow up on that.
But he could go one step further and organize anyone else that was affected, vet them, and then add them to the GoFundMe, get a total, and then hit that goal.
Yeah, if you need help, we'll help you out.
But then again, that you're just passing off their fucking debt to somebody else. Like,
oh, we're going
to
shank that motherfucker that organized this. Don't get it twisted.
What I'm talking about is like, you know, okay, this person's out $1,000, but you're asking for other people to help recruit your money back. But now all those people are out of like whatever sum.
Dude, it's like donating. You can add, you know, just have a pledge fund, anywhere from $1 to $20.
Yeah.
I saw the effects of what a GoFundMe could do with Matt. With Matt, so it definitely helps.
Yeah.
So, like I said, just a little money here or there.
Yeah. You know. Don't be asking for like, you know, I mean, you want to set a goal, and you want to set a pledge, denomination that's reasonable.
Dude, people be spending $16-$20 for avocado toast out here every fucking day. Come on now.
Hey, we spent $60 in the game.
They do that and then complain about how high rent is.
Yeah, exactly.
That's just fucking high, though.
All right, were there any others on the B2Bs?
Yeah, we got one from Dirty Stew.
Wait, I got to throw something in here real quick. So there's this thing called Ask Reddit where people ask random ass questions. And there's a question on here that says, blind people on Reddit, what are your dreams like?
What the fuck?
Hold on.
Blind people on Reddit. They can't fucking read this shit.
So they don't need to read, but they can have it. They can have it. It's read to them. Voice
Reddit.
Yeah. It's read to them. Hold on. Cake Man said this. It's called Weekend Pussy Con.
Oh, I like it. You know what? That's a winner.
Yeah. Yeah, you never watched? There's a guy on YouTube. Forget his fucking name.
I know you're talking about the guy who like does the roller coaster rides and stuff, right?
That guy's dope. And then there's a girl that she used to have sight, but now she's blind. So she has both experiences, and she still uses an iPhone, but it just says everything to her.
Yep. Well, I know how to turn that feature on. It's fucking
trippy.
It's dope, but annoying as fuck when you turn it off. It's like, how the fuck do I turn it off? Because it reads everything to you.
Everything you touch, it'll read it off. And like, you have to like, and you can't just, because usually on your phone, you touch it once and it opens it up. Yeah. When you have that assistant on, you have to like tap it twice. Or actually sometimes three times.
What was that other B2B?
So we got a live one, and then we have one from Dirty Stew.
All right, read that Dirty Stew. We love him.
Dirty Stew, we were supposed to research this, but basically, who are your top five porn stars of all time?
Well, we got to put a pin in that. I got to research, man.
You don't remember who you were fapping to back in the day?
I do, but I want to carefully give
I thought we answered that question.
I kind of feel like we did, like, top one.
Yeah.
Top five.
I want a good list on this. Let's come back to that one. That's a save for next.
And then our live one is from Wild Alb. Which Infinity War actress would you smash?
All of them.
Okay.
How about we add? How about this? Murder, fuck.
Murder, death, kill.
Fuck, marry, kill.
That one. I couldn't think of how it goes.
Yeah, but.
I'm fucking Scarlett Johansson. You know, I mean, she's still thickness and badness. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? What's her name? Gamora getting broke off, or am I killing her? What I need to do?
That's up to you. You killing her?
Marry, fuck, kill.
I guess
fuck, marry, kill.
I'm marrying Gamora, and I guess I'm killing Pepper Potts. I don't know.
All right. I'm probably gonna kill Scarlet Witch.
Damn.
Yeah, killing Scarlet Witch.
Cold world.
I'm marrying Black Widow. Marrying Scarlet.
There you go.
Beat that up all day. And then I'd smash Nebula.
Oh, Nebula is bad. Especially out that makeup.
Yeah, I'd smash. She got red hair. Oh, yeah. Fire crotch.
She was fucking great in
smashing.
Welcome to the Jungle, Jumanji.
Yeah. Blue, what you got? Homesteader.
Shit. I'm going to say I am marrying Gamora, because she's fine as fuck.
Yep.
Especially when she's blue. But,
wait, Gamora's green?
No, I know she's green, but I'm talking about the actress. Avatar. She's in Avatar.
Oh, so you want that tail.
I am killing... probably, yeah, probably Scarlett Jo Witch, because she doesn't, every time I see her, I think of this Olsen twin, so I see her as like a little kid.
She's an Olsen, so.
I know she's an Olsen, but I see the Olsen twins in her. And I will smash Scarlett Johansson.
There we go.
All right.
Jonas, what you got?
I'm marrying Zoe Saldana. I'm smashing ScarJo. And I'm killing Nebula.
Oh. Okay.
Okay. All right. All right. I'm gonna.
No one picked Michonne.
Oh wait, no.
Nah.
Well, I respect her.
Yeah. Oh, I'm unzipping respect.
Some respect.
Shuri.
Wait, no?
Sure. Because she plays a teenager, even though she's not. Oh, I
feel it.
I can't do it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I feel it.
I thought you were gonna put Groot in your ass, though.
No, that's your thing.
Oh, okay.
You've been sending me videos like looking like that. I'm like, oh, okay. I can see what you're into now.
You know, don't kick Shay.
Yeah, definitely
kill her. All right, so that was all our B's and BTIs. Y'all want to round it on up? We got stuff that we'll save for next week. Yeah. Obviously, everybody's going to see Infinity War. We got plenty to discuss on that. And we're going to revisit God of War. And we have not forgotten that Lost in Space, we didn't give our final reviews on that.
No, we did not. I'm still watching it.
Actually, I finished it, so we'll be good. We'll be able to get Stitch's take.
I had a quick question for you guys.
What you got?
Regarding God of War. So first, it started off with Greek mythology, and now we're on Norse mythology, right?
Norse.
What do you think will be that if they were to continue it on, where would they go?
Egyptian.
I'd be down for Egyptian. Ooh, don't get me wrong. I'd be down for Mayan.
Actually, you know what I'd be down for? Because nobody's done anything like it yet. Is some Indian mythology. There's a shitload of gods.
Yeah. You know what? You should have played Lost Legacy.
Yeah. Uncharted Lost Legacy. Yeah. They covered a bunch of that.
That was good on that. I can let you borrow it, man. It was really good.
It was
good
fun. I did like the combo of it. I mean, I did like the history of India because Zoe was like, oh, I'm part Indian. We're going to go through my history. I'm like, okay. This is great.
I got to go back and play that.
Yeah. I
got to kill them other gods first, though.
I like to see them, like, maybe Chinese mythology in there, too.
Oh,
like,
that would be good, too.
They got some crazy-ass stories in there, too.
But I see Egyptian coming, like, right after.
Or even fucking Christianity. Fuck it.
Well, he would have to. Well, no.
There's not enough gods, bro.
Egyptian wouldn't work.
There's only three. Or he's got angels.
Egyptian wouldn't work unless he went back in time.
Yeah, well,
he's already way forward of.
Well, yeah, but I mean,
with portals and shit.
In the God of War series, they have done prequels.
Well, and they've already talked about time travel in this game. So
there you go.
Yeah.
You can play around.
At least time stopping.
Yeah.
Yes.
You don't do it.
No. But I mean, you have a time slowing ability.
Yeah. You could go a whole lot of places with this fucking that fucking mythology. Mm-hmm. Good shit. All right, let's round it on up. You know, I'm watching goddamn Infinity War tomorrow on Thursday, and I'm playing more Fortnite, hopefully with Stitch later on. What y'all got
in there?
Old Ninja.
Tomorrow, I'm probably not going to be able to watch Infinity War. I'm going to the San Francisco 49ers draft party, so I'll be in the city probably most of the night doing that. I'm probably going to catch Infinity War kind of late, maybe like Sunday night-ish.
Okay.
I think I got something going on Saturday. I think another birthday gig, but we'll see if that pans out. And then it's kind of about it. Killing more gods. And then Westworld, which we haven't talked about, season two. I think two or three episodes are out, so I'm probably going to try to catch up on that. And that's kind of about it.
Blue, what you got?
Is it you are or your?
Depends on
the way. Like I say, you're my boy, Blue.
Oh, you are my boy.
Well, if you want to be, like, not conjugated, yeah, it's you are my boy, but you can say you're. You're my boy, Blue.
Because I was going to say, so next Monday is your boy Blue's birthday.
Oh!
So I'm actually going to be flying out to Hawaii tomorrow with the Sweetness. We did this last year, and we had a lot of fun, so we're going to be staying in Kauai, which it kind of sucks because they've been hit with, I think it was two weekends ago, they were hit with, like, the record-breaking amount of rain. They had 27 inches in 24 hours.
That's a lot, she said.
Yeah. Oh!
That's good. But luckily, sadly, it was only at the north side of the island, which is close to where we're going to actually be staying at, but it's not going to affect us too much, but it's still kind of raining there, but it's fucking tropical place, so I'm not really sweating it too much, but we'll see how it goes. I'm definitely looking forward to that.
Take some pictures.
Oh, yeah, I'm definitely going to take some pictures. Last year, I bought my drone to take with me to Hawaii, but I don't think I'm going to take it with me this time. I'm just going to take my camera and take some pictures, but yeah, that's pretty much it. Once I come come back, I'm gonna get back to killing gods.
There you go,
Cronus. You can borrow my Osmo if you want and do some like blogging, but I just probably wouldn't want to.
It's kind of raining too. So, but wait, there was one thing I was gonna say. Oh, we're gonna do this one event. There's this thing. It's an abandoned aqueduct. I think I pronounced that right. And there's a company that bought that out, and you can go tubing in that now.
So like, sounds fucking dope.
It's like an hour and a half ride, and it's almost like, you know how I hear Raging Waters have like the Lazy Rich River that goes around.
Yep.
And it's just you just going down this aqueduct, and it's all open. There's some parts where it goes kind of in tunnels and stuff like that. So the company actually give you headlamps, so you can turn it on and whatever. Not
they give you head.
Yeah, they give you
26 inches.
Take it deep. But anyway, so yeah, we're gonna be doing that this time, and we're gonna do some hiking. We're only staying on one island this time. We're not gonna island hop like we did last time, but yeah, it's gonna be a lot of fun, I'm hoping.
Good shit. Cronus, what you got?
Not much this weekend. I'm trying to watch Infinity War. I think you're going to watch The Kid for us. You are.
Someone's going to. We'll talk about the times offline. I don't know when it's happening.
I don't fucking know. I leave it to the wolves normally, so it's all good. It fucking works itself out, you know what I mean? Yeah, we're working on getting some other interviews coming up. I know Jay Trees has expressed some interest coming back on the podcast. So, yeah, that'd be cool to have him back on. So he's got a new lineup.
Good fucking shit.
Hey, and show your boy Blue some love. Use the hashtag You're My Boy Blue Happy Birthday. Last year I tried using Happy Birthday Blue, and it didn't work out too well because what's his name? Jay-Z and Beyonce's daughter name is Blue, and there was all a bunch of Happy Birthday for her. So fuck that little girl. No, I was joking.
You don't know her. You know Blue though.
Yeah.
Damn. Be hot coming for you. All right. Check us out on the interwebs at BTHAMBTI on Twitter. That's BTHAMBTI. Check us out on SoundCloud, Stitcher, Player FM, and Apple Podcasts. Check us out on there. Check out on Amazon. We have an app on there as well. Check out our official page at binhatproductions.com/BTHAMBTI. We're on Instagram as well with BTHAMBTI. Facebook, you can check out Black and Black Time Stupidity or BTHAMBTI. We're on there.
I want some Symbiote Fuda anime. That's what I want.
Doing
make it so.
Too much.
What's that?
Boy.
Snava? What's that one site that had the... Oh God, I can't even the name of it. I can find it for a second. Quick. Chad Base. They probably have some soon.
There you go.
Shade Base?